all the best sports shows, all the best games on 101.5 FM and 1570 AM for your college sports, University of South Dakota. For NHL coverage, Minnesota Wild. For NBA coverage, Minnesota Timberwolves. For MLB coverage, Chicago Cubs. And the best games in both college and the pros with the ESPN Radio featured games. Never miss out on the action.
Forget the ramps and hassles when hauling. They are built to tilt. Tilt Bed Trailers, made at Holstein Fabrication and Holstein Manufacturing.
We're excited to now offer one of the best tilt bed trailers on the market, ranging from 22 to 28 feet in length. And like everything we manufacture, these trailers are built to work, last, and make your life easier. Haul with confidence when you hook up to a tilt bed trailer made at Holstein Fabrication and Holstein Manufacturing. Visit us online today at HolsteinMFG.com.
Senior Lafferty Tuition Foundation awards tuition scholarships to students that attend a Catholic school in the Diocese of Sioux City. By contributing to MLTF, donors are eligible to receive a 75% tax credit from the state of Iowa. There is no other charitable gift that offers you a credit like that. It is also the perfect time of year to consider a gift of grain to MLTF. You can find more information about MLTF at scdiocese.org under the Giving tab. Please consider a gift to MLTF to give the gift of Catholic education.
Since the 1980s, Colbeck Incorporated has been a family-run business providing their customers with quality wood and feed grinding services throughout Northwest Iowa. Colbeck Incorporated knows that your time is valuable, and they pride themselves on getting the job done in a prompt and reliable fashion. Local cattle feeders have been relying on Colbeck Incorporated hay grinding for 30 years, and Brian and Kevin are proud of their partnerships they've built with their customers. Whether it's grinding, mulch, or hauling, call Colbeck Incorporated today and see what they can do for you.
AgriVision Equipment and ExactEmerge Planter Technology is here to help you maximize your yield and efficiency, along with a proven 8 bushel per acre yield advantage because of the pinpoint accuracy of seed depth and placement. You can cover 50 acres per hour without compromising your stand. We know the risk of planting outside the optimal planting window, so don't let the weather control your bottom line. When you partner with AgriVision Equipment, you get access to the best service and technology support in the area. And visit any one of our 15 locations today to learn more about our large selection of new and used planters. AgriVision Equipment, focused on your future.
Reliance means being dependable. And when it comes to comfort in your home, you want Reliance from a place you can trust with a product you can count on. That's why Marcus Lumber stocks Reliance brand water heaters. Because with Reliance in the name, it's the brand you can trust. Marcus Lumber has been stocking and installing Reliance water heaters for decades. So choose the name you trust for your home. Choose Marcus Lumber and Reliance water heaters.
Hello and welcome to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Jays basketball is on the air. Tonight, the Jays of Gehlen Catholic take on the Hawks of Hartley Melvin Sanborn. My name is Matt Schilling, and tonight joining me is Drew Bickford. And Drew, the Jays have had a bit of a, they've drawn a bit of the short straw the last few games, especially against Trinity and then the last game against Harris Lake Park.
They've had some really close games, just haven't been able to close them out. A lot of the games, the last three, four games, it seems like they played one really good half and one half that they got behind. The key is to put together a full game for these guys. Just haven't quite been able to get over the hump yet.
They did a great job of fighting back in that last game versus Harris Lake Park. They started out with an 11-0 deficit, fought their way back, and evened it up early in the third quarter, especially the Rizaya Sitzman three buzzer beater at the end of the third.
Yeah, they just seem to get more and more momentum in the second half and close the gap, and then just couldn't get past tying the game.
Tonight the Jays will be without Hallie Waldenbach, and we kind of knew that going in, a little bit of a knee injury. But also for tonight's game, Nevaeh Hodgson will also be out of the ball game.
And Nevaeh is she's one of the leaders. If you watch Gehlen, she's one of the vocal leaders out on the court. Averaging 6.2 points per game and just under 4 rebounds per game. But she's just kind of the floor general, knowing where people should be on defense, and just has played a lot of basketball. So that may be a bigger loss than what the stats say.
We'll see if Sammy Zubrod can step up in her place. Sammy has shown a lot of physicality in the paint for the Jays this season.
Yes, she has. The post they have just aren't very deep. They don't have a lot of size, so they may even go to more of a guard lineup. I know Kennedy Paulson has come in and give some good time, but just don't have a lot of size. Bella Schrader is somebody who's been added to the roster. Be curious to see if they use her size. But yeah, we'll see what happens tonight.
Rizaya Sitzman has always been the Jays' leader this season in scoring. What about the Hawks?
They have quite a bit of size, so that'll be interesting how the Jays handle that. Abby Duma is averaging 11 points per game, and Mariah Otto 12, Kylie Shipoff 11. So pretty even scoring. There's three scores over 10 points, and a couple girls 6 foot or over. So it's going to be tough for the Jays to keep them off the boards, and that may be kind of the key to the game, is keeping the bigs off the boards for HMS.
We will bring you starting lineups next on Fuller Digital Solutions and FullerDigital.net.
Whether you are combining, hauling grain, or heating your home, fuel powers the fall. When it comes to energy, you need a company who is trustworthy, understands your needs, and who delivers to you. A company who is local, reliable, and affordable. That company is Ag State. Ag State Energy is clean, comfortable, convenient, while staying competitively priced for our customers. Give Laura Sanguin or Seth Duff a call for all your energy needs.
MHI and Cuso of Cherokee are on the move, expanding, and in need of residential treatment workers, psychiatric security specialists, and LPNs.
We deal with disorders that you can't see. You get to help people who are in desperate need of help. And helping those people actually helps the community as well.
The benefits here, I think, are top-notch. That was why I came here.
To learn more and to apply, visit governmentjobs.com.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. We will turn things over to our public address announcer.
Good evening. Welcome to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym here at Gehlen Catholic for tonight's boy-girl varsity doubleheader. Let's extend a special welcome to our guests, the Hawks from Hartley, Melvin Sanborn. Gehlen Catholic Schools encourage positive sportsmanship and behavior at the game tonight. By practicing good sportsmanship, you will help make tonight's game one to remember. Let's give a hand for our officials for tonight's game: Royce Raniger, Nick Nelson, and Jason Slaughter. Now let's welcome the coaches. The Hawks are coached by Jenny Van Otterloo and Ashley Tessum. They're assisted by Russ Spear. The Jays are coached by Brandon Schecker, assisted by Brian Kolbeck. And now the starters. For the Hawks, a junior, number 2, Gracie Knobloch. For the Jays, a sophomore, number 1, Grace Kellen. For the Hawks, a junior, number 14, Kylie Shipoff. For the Jays, a junior, number 3, Rizea Sitzman. For the Hawks, a junior, number 20, Abby Dalma. For the Jays, a senior, number 10, Haley Poland. For the Hawks, a sophomore, number 21, Mariah Otto. For the Jays, a junior, number 11, Emerson Schmidt. For the Hawks, a junior, number 23, Frankie Money. And for the Jays, a junior, number 42, Sammy Zubrod. Please stand and remove your hats as the Gehlen Pep Band performs our national anthem.
Reliance means being dependable. And when it comes to comfort in your home, you want Reliance from a place you can trust with a product you can count on. That's why Marcus Lumber stocks Reliance brand water heaters. Because with Reliance in the name, it's the brand you can trust. Marcus Lumber has been stocking and installing Reliance water heaters for decades. So choose the name you trust for your home. Choose Marcus Lumber and Reliance water heaters.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling here with you alongside Drew Bickford. Drew, we are getting ready for tonight's tip-off.
Really curious to see what the Jays come out defensively. Obviously, keeping HMS out of the paint is going to be a key. And then rebounding. So it'll be interesting to see how physical they are down low, how they keep them off the boards.
As we get ready for the opening tip, a bit of a size mismatch, and the Hawks will control this one right off the bat. Otto, left wing, cross court, right side of the paint, shot put up, no good, and we're going to have a foul on the floor. Foul's going to be on Rizaiah Sitzman. That's her first, team's first of the first quarter. Reminder that those fouls do reset every quarter. Ball inbounded to Dalma. Near the top of the key, Moni. Back out to Dalma. Drives the baseline. We're going to have a walk. Ship off walk as she was driving the baseline.
Had the right move. Just shuffled the feet before she put the ball down.
Tonight's scoreboard brought to you by Ag State. Shot clock in the lower right, scoreboard in the lower left, and the bottom line is brought to you by Schuster Trucking. Sitzman. Schmidt with it now. Bounce pass hard to Haley Poland. Between the circles, kick left to Sitzman. Now near the top of the key, Grace Kellen on the floor. Grace stops, and we're going to have a walk with a basketball.
Didn't come to a jump stop. That's tough not to travel once that happens.
0-0, 7:22 left to go in the first. Moni brought it up over the timeline, passes left to Otto. Otto near the top of the key, looking for a little bit of help. Passes right, Moni. Now Dalma. Knobloch, first time we mentioned her. As I think that's going to be, I think they might have been touched by Otto as it went out of bounds.
Tipped a couple times and last off HMS.
Haley pulling the inbounder, bounce pass in, and HMS is showing a high pressure in the backcourt. Poland able to bring it up over the timeline with a left hand. It's going to be off of Knobloch on the floor. Poland gets it back. Sitzman drives the lane, puts up a left hand. No good. Rebound. Fought for. Out of bounds. Saved by the Hawks. Brought up the floor now by Otto. And she took a tumble, and Haley Poland kicked it out of bounds.
A lot of energy used right there in the corner.
A lot of energy.
A lot of bodies on the ground.
Moni, the freshman, brought it up the floor for the Hawks. Kicks it into Shipoff. Shipoff drives the baseline, right side of the paint. Fought for underneath. Now kicked out in the far corner. They're going to say it was touched by Haley Poland. It will be Hawks ball in that far corner. Still 0-0.
One thing, looking at the HMS roster, I don't see any seniors. So a lot of youth. A lot of juniors on the team, but still a lot of youth.
Hawks looking to get the ball in. And that one was almost intercepted by Schmidt. But again, the Hawks' height advantage drives the paint, puts it up off the back iron. No good from Shipoff. She's able to get her own putback. And the Hawks lead this one 2-0. Haley pulling the inbounder. Bounce pass into Grace Kellen. 6:08 left to go in the first. Grace Kellen brings it up the floor. Right side of the paint. Puts it up. Tries a layup. I think that was poked at partially by Dalma. And we're going to have a held ball.
With the height HMS has, if you don't go in and kind of make contact with their bigs, they're going to block a lot of shots.
Schmidt, the inbounder, bounce pass, try to get it to Sitzman. Haley Poland able to come up with it, gets it to Sitzman, drives near the baseline, got it to Zubrod, bounced off her hand, and it turned over to Frankie Moni. Contact heavy there, no call, kicked out, Moni. Far corner, Grace Kellen tried to intercept that one. Layup up and in by Abby Dalma.
There's that size right there. Just throws it up down low, and Dalma went and got it.
Kellen, nice. Quickly up the floor, and she's able to lay it in. First 2 points of the ball. Ball game for the Jays. One thing that's a little bit impressive here for the Jays is they're not letting this one get away from them here early. 5:18 left to go in the first. Despite the size advantages, Zubra did a nice job of getting a body on Dalma and picking that pass off.
I was surprised the Jays came out man-to-man. I thought maybe they'd do something to kind of clog the lane. But they've been doing a really good job of clogging it. Once the ball's thrown into the paint, they've really clogged it.
Sitzman with that left-handed layup. As Knobloch brings up the ball, kicks it left to Mone. Mone tries to get it down low through the hands of Dalma. Caught on the boundary. Still tightroping the boundary is Shipoff. Shipoff in the far corner, intercepted by Zubrod. Zubrod bounce pass to Sitzman, will bring it ahead for the Jays. Had a leader with Grace Kellen. Now Grace, three, no good. Rebound by Shipoff. Mone brings it up the floor for the Hawks. Gets it down low, layup up and in for Dalma. She now has four. Grace Kellen brings it up the floor, spots up a three and walks with a basketball.
Grace couldn't decide if she wanted to shoot that or drive it. And
I was just going to say, Grace got to make that decision earlier. She's got to make that jump stop and go ahead and pull the trigger on a three. Three new Hawks, three new Jays, six new birds in the game. Van Ness brings it up over the timeline with a right hand, pushes it right to Knobloch. Knobloch gets it down low, throws it away, out of bounds. It will be Jays basketball. I think if the Jays are able to keep this one close going into the fourth quarter, it's anybody's ball game.
Yeah, they've been a team that kind of lets teams go on runs and then can't close the gap. So just avoid the big swings one way or the other.
Lubin gets it over Sitzman, three, no. And Fender is going to be off of her foot, out of bounds, back to the Hawks. And the Hawks were showing zone to the Jays. Looks like the Jays are going to show some pressure defense here. Into Knobloch, guarded by KP. Knobloch will bring it up the floor, guarded by Paulson. Switch, and that one tries it. They've been trying to get up over to get the height advantage over the Jays, and they're not able to. They've thrown away a lot of balls here, Drew.
Just a little bit of token pressure on the ball and makes it a little bit tougher pass. You're on the move.
3:30 left to go in the first. Sitzman passes right to Paulson, back to Sitzman between the circles. Spots up a deep three, in and out, and back toward the rim. No good. Fought for on the baseline. We're going to have a held ball. It's going to be a jump ball. It'll be Hawks ball.
That's one that the Jays aren't a great three-point shooting team. They do take quite a few. But Haley Lubin's the leading three-point shooter at 30%. Nobody else is over 25 is Isaiah Sitzman.
Van Ness brings it up over the timeline, fought for on the floor. I think we're going to have a held ball. We do. It's going to be Jays basketball with 3:08 left to go in the first quarter. Reminder to like and subscribe this YouTube channel. That way you'll know whenever we go live. We don't go live again until January. The next Jays game will be against St. Mary's. It'll be at St. Mary's and on their Fuller Digital channel. That one poked out of bounds. Will remain Jays basketball off of Kylie Shipoff. A couple new Hawks coming in the ball game. Both teams rotating highly.
HMS back in the 2-3 now. And really see if they can get the ball into the middle. Right now, not a ton of cutters. They're kind of staying on the outside, but trying to leave that middle open. Haven't gotten there yet. There's one right there.
Floater, partially blocked. No good. Rebound by Dalma. Up the floor comes Mone. Mone gets it to Otto. Otto drives paint, puts it up and in. Her first 2 points of the ball game. It's 8-4. 2:30 left to go in this first quarter. Sitzman passes left to Fender. Fender back out to Sitzman. Jays did a nice job a few times previous as Lubin takes the three, no good. I was saying they did a good job a few times before with ball rotation, finding Sitzman for the open three as Shipoff takes the three herself, no good. Rebound put up and in by Otto. What I was saying is they did a good job of moving the ball around, getting Sitzman the wide open shot. She wasn't able to get it to fall. Back to Sitzman. She thought about taking the three, drives left side of the paint, puts it up off the back iron and down. Sitzman now with four, 8-6. I'm sorry, 10-6. Shot put up. That was a little bit too easy there for Shipoff.
Abby Dalma, a great job kind of sealing off the lane for an easy layup.
12-6, Larissa Polin drives toward the paint, bounce pass start. Haley Lubin takes a step, puts it up and in. Haley Lubin with two. It's 12-8. She stepped up into a nice little role here this year. Down low, Haley puts up the defense. Ball fought for, come away with by Fender. Fender drives right side of the paint, has a trailer, hits her arm. She catches it as her right foot goes out of bounds on the baseline.
That there's the length right there for HMS. That's tough. Layups are not easy when you're going in against six-footers.
Three new Jays back into the ballgame, or three returning Jays, I guess, as Moni will bring the ball up for HMS. Feed down low, fought for, three-point, ship off, good. Ship off with seven. It's now 15-8 in the waning seconds of the first quarter to Larissa Polin in the paint. She fumbles around with the ball. She's on the floor with it. We're going to have a held ball. We're going to have a timeout. 30-second timeout. Back in 30, you're watching Jays and Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions.
MHI and Cuso of Cherokee are on the move, expanding, and in need of residential treatment workers, psychiatric security specialists, and LPNs.
We deal with disorders that you can't see. You get to help people who are in desperate need of help. And helping those people actually helps the community as well.
The benefits here, I think, are top-notch. That was why I came here.
To learn more and to apply, visit governmentjobs.com.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling and Drew Bickford here. And the Jays trail this one by seven.
Yeah, this 2-3 is giving a little bit of problems. The key is, when they're getting it to the free throw line, those back three are sucking up pretty high. It'll be interesting to see if Colbeck and Schecker can have some backdoor cuts, maybe a little bounce pass down the baseline for layup.
Zubrod tries to save that one, picked up by Moni. 27 seconds left to go. Shot clock is now turned off. Ship off, gets it down low, puts up a shot, does Otto before she is fouled by Zubrod. The shot did not fall. It's going to be Zubrod's first. It's only the second foul of the game, and both of them are on the Jays. Mariah Otto to the line. She puts up the first, knocks it down. She now has five. School's out for winter starting next Thursday. Thursday is the first day of winter break. That one bounces out, no good. Sitzman brings it up the floor, left hand hard toward the baseline, puts up a floater, no good, fouled in the process. Foul is going to be on 10, Addison Sheeler. That's going to be her first. It's going to be the team's first. Sitzman the line to shoot two, 15 seconds left here to go in this first quarter. That one rattles around and down. I think it's Christmas PJ night in the student section for the Jays as Sitzman puts up the second off the front iron. No good. Rebound by Dalma. Quickly up the floor. Moni with a right hand pushes right. Now down low. That one intercepted by Sitzman. Quickly driving to the paint. Puts up right hand. No basket, but a foul. She will go to the line to shoot two with 1.9 left.
Not a lot of contact there. A lot more contact the rest of the game, it seemed like, but... I was just talking during the break, only one foul called so far in the game, and now the whistles have picked up a little bit.
That foul is the second on Sheeler. First free throw attempt, true. 16-10. Second free throw attempt, put up, out, no good. Rebound by the Hawks. And the first quarter ends, Jays trailing 16-10. We'll be back with second quarter action. You're watching Jays and Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions and FullerDigital.com.
Catholic in Lamar's, Iowa, instills respect and Christian values in a caring environment for students preschool through 12th grade. Teachers and staff go above and beyond to provide a high-quality education and are dedicated to student success. We are a community striving to live God's Word each day through academics, service opportunities, athletics, and so much more. Gehlen Catholic School, in partnership with Spalding Catholic School, all are welcome to experience excellence in education and leadership through Christ.
Sitzman Construction, Lamar's, general contractors you can trust with the job you need done, when you need it done. Call Jeremy at Sitzman Construction when you need a remodel or a complete build, and they work with BPS Buildings. Jeremy takes the time to know what you need. Past clients say he's reliable, honest, fair-minded, and reasonably priced. Contact Jeremy at Sitzman Construction. Jeremy and his crew will satisfy all of your construction needs. 712-540-2731.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford, and the Jays trail this one by six. Sitzman has been all the scoring for the most part for the Jays. She has 6 points for the Jays.
Yeah, started off the first quarter, a close game, and then HMS wanted a little run. Jays kind of lucky to be within six, probably.
Corner, Knobloch, tries to get it down low. I think that's the Hawks' plan for tonight. Throw it over the height deficiency of the Jays as that one from Moni goes off the back iron, no good. Shot by Twos, and she is fouled on the play. Foul is going to be on Sammy Zubrod. That's her second foul, team's first of the second quarter.
And that could be a problem with Zubrod having her second already. We were talking before the game how size is not one of the strengths for the Jays. Having the biggest post out isn't going to be pleasant for the Jays.
Second free throw attempt is knocked down by Twos. 18-10, the score. Sitzman with a left hand, drives, puts it up. That one knocked away, fought for it on the floor, and it's going to stay Jays basketball. We've got a lot of local great sponsors that help bring this action to the Hartley, Melvin, Sanborn area, as well as to the Gehlen Catholic area. I think there was some discussion that the shot clock should not have been reset. Jason Slaughter goes over to the scorer's table, gives him the correct time that should be on that clock, on the shot clock. Of course, tonight's clock is brought to you by, scoreboard is brought to you by Ag State. Shot clock in the lower right-hand corner, they got that adjusted. And the bottom line is brought to you by Schuster Trucking. Haley Lubin, the inbounder, gets it into, try to get into Sitzman. Intercepted by Shipoff. She stops, hands it off to Moni. Gets it down low. Otto fighting. Back down to Otto. Otto with it in the paint, and we're going to have a jump ball. It'll remain Hawks basketball on that end of the floor.
They are letting a lot of contact go down there. Been real physical down in the paint.
Knobloch, the inbounder, gets it in to Shipoff. Ship off beyond the arc. Moni beyond the three-point line. She is way deep, and I thought she was going to put one up. Shot up and in for Otto. She now has 7 on the night, and it's 20-10. Sitzman, top of the key, over to Haley Lubin. Open, 3, knocks it down. Haley Lubin has 5. Moni over to Shipoff, cross court to Knobloch, gets it down low, and a foul committed by Emerson Schmidt. It's going to be Schmidt's first, team's second of the second quarter.
They're trying to clog that paint, but the size advantage has just been too much.
I think the Jays are happy to give up that 3. Allow the Hawks to shoot the 3, and the Hawks are saying,
I agree.
No thank you.
I agree.
I'd rather take the 2 down low, as the first one is up and in for Otto. Haley Lubin goes out of the ball, Poland goes out of the ball game. Otto knocked on the second, 22-13. Grace Kellen drives left side of the paint, puts up a shot, no good. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Foul's going to be on number 12, Eliza Tews. That's her first, team's first of the second quarter. Kellen at the line, puts up the first, off the back iron, no good. Otto goes out. Dama comes in. Length did not get off the floor for the Jays. Second one, banks open late here in Lamar's. Claim that last time on the air, claim it again tonight. Knobloch brings it up over the timeline with a right hand. Get it to cross court to ship off, back to Knobloch. Puts up a three off the front iron, no good. Fought for it on the floor. Lubin, oh, they're going to say it was off of Dauma. Oh, I'm sorry, corrected call. I thought that was off of Lubin down on the baseline.
I would have been surprised if they kept that.
Quick trigger from Monet, no good. Rebound, fought for. It's going to be a held ball, and it's going to be Jay's basketball with 6:15 left to go in the second. Ryan Wilchin joins us at halftime as Sitzman brings the ball up. Kellen down low. That shot just absolutely destroyed. Lubin over to Poland. Puts up a three off the front iron, no good. Rebound by Shipoff. Knobloch brings it up the floor for the Hawks. Kicks it left. Grace Kellen tries to steal that one away. Knobloch with it now. Jays look like they're in a little bit of a zone right now. That one almost stolen away by Kellen. Instead, knocked out of bounds. Will remain HMS basketball. HMS with an 8-point lead, 5:39 left to go in the second. Ball inbounded to Shipoff, and Kellen knocks that one out of bounds. Give that to Grace Kellen. She is flying all over the court here. Knobloch gets it down low, off the bottom of the backboard, no good. And we're going to have a travel.
She thought she had numbers and wanted to get out and run, but didn't see that defender standing there and shuffled the feet.
Knobloch gets it in. Thought about a three. Knobloch now gets it down low. Double team. Thought I saw some shuffling feet there. They're going to say a foul is on the floor.
She definitely went up and down, but maybe her toes stayed on the ground.
I'll say it was on Emerson Schmidt. That's going to be her second, team's third, as it looks like Fender and Paulson will come into the ball game. Arissa Polin and Emerson Schmidt come out of the ball game. Knobloch, the inbounder, gets it in, top of the key to Van Ness, quickly over, now in the near corner. Knobloch started to go in, then back out. Quick layup up and in for Mariah Otto. She has 11. Sitzman will bring it up the floor. 5 minutes left to go here in the second. Sitzman spinning. Haley Lubin puts up a three with a nice screen by Sitzman. Gets the rebound, puts up a shot, no good. Rebound by Knobloch. Quickly ahead. Dauma puts up the shot. No good, and we're going to have a foul. Foul is going to be on Grace Kellen. That's her first, team's fourth.
Thought they'd give her the continuation, give her two shots, but they sit on the floor.
Coach Shecker was looking for a travel on that one, too.
I think the contact caused the travel, but I'm sure Brandon wants that call, though.
Quick trigger, three, no good. Rebound over the back by Otto, puts the put back in. She now has 13. It's 26 to 14.
Grace Kellen did a great job of boxing out. Really surprised that he called over the back there.
Sitzman directing traffic, tries a head fake, drives for the baseline, and they're going to have a foul. That one's going to be on Lindsay Van Ness. That's going to be her first, team's second of the second quarter. 4:28 left to go in the second. Fresh shot clock. Haley Lubin, the inbounder, looking to get it in. Ah! It was
the baseline.
Blocked by Dalma, and she was still out of bounds. I think I've seen that a couple times here this year for the Jays. Frankie Mone bringing it up the floor for the Hawks. Mone kicks right to Shipoff. Shipoff now, shot, no good, rebound. J.C. Fender. J.C. in the corner falls to the ground and travels with a basketball.
Got the rebound, took one dribble right back into that corner.
And fell to the ground.
That's no man's land to the corner.
Van Ness, the inbounder, gets it in to Dalma. Dalma down low. It's going to be off of Shipoff. And it'll be Jay's basketball just about halfway through this second quarter. Subs in now. Jim filling up all right here for a Friday night as Sitzman brings it up the floor. Right side of the paint, backs up, kicks it. Haley Lubin squared up a three and walked with the basketball.
Haley's going to have a lot of open three-point shots because it's been the bigs that have been guarding her, and they want to sit in the paint and block shots, and that one, she pulled her out away from the hoop a little bit, but then shuffled the feet.
Van Ness, the inbounder, gets it into Mone. Mone quickly ahead to Scheller. Down low. That one's blocked out of the hands of Twos, not a bounds. Remains Hawks basketball. Scheller looking to inbound. Gets it into Van Ness. Mone, pump fake. She is trapped by Grace Kellen. Great defense, and we're going to have a
timeout.
I think we're going to have a timeout. Officials are going to talk about it here real quick before anything's called. They're going to give them the timeout. Nope. They're going to say no timeout. They're going to say the ball was not possessed. Head coach is going to argue for just a second, relents. It'll be Jay's basketball trailing by 12. Paulson into Lubin. Lubin cross court to Kellen. Kellen with a couple of those fingers taped. Sitzman left side, right side of the paint. Paulson over to, I keep wanting to say Bonderson. It's not, it's Schmidt. Schmidt puts up a shot, no good. Sitzman with a rebound, put back, good. Sitzman with 8.
Her first two of the second quarter.
10-point ball game as that ball is thrown out of bounds. We'll come back to the Jays. 3:12 left to go in the quarter. Larissa Poland will come in. Haven't seen a whole lot out of Larissa Poland here tonight.
Not yet. Hopefully she can get going. HMS is doing a great job of breaking the press. It's after they're getting it past half court. They have one more pass at the layup, and that they're just overthrowing that pass.
Poland kicks it to Lubin, now Schmidt. Larissa Poland thought she could have pulled the trigger. She kicks it out now. Lubin, that one no good. Rebound, fought for on the floor, picked up by Dalma. Mone will bring it up the floor for the Hawks. Kicks it into the near corner. Shot up and in for Lindsey Van Ness. Nice little finessing underhand by Van Ness. Larissa Poland gets it to Paulson. Paulson near the baseline. Out to Sitzman. Bounce pass in. Shot no good from Paulson. Out of bounds. I believe it's going to remain Jay's basketball here on the baseline.
I don't think she meant to pass that, but it turned out to be a great pass.
2:16 left to go here in the second. Sitzman will be the inbounder. Sitzman inbound on the baseline. And Zubrod will come into the ball game now. Last minute sub. Official allowed it.
Hopefully she can stay out of their third foul in the last 2:16 here.
Sitzman inbound, bounce pass to Poland. Tried to bounce pass to Sitzman. That one knocked out of bounds nicely by Gracie Knobloch. Sideline inbound for Haley Poland. Bounce pass into Sitzman, double teamed. Lubin, three, no good. It's going to be off the hands of Zubrod out of bounds.
They tried to pull some defenders away from the hoop and isolate Rizea, and HMS wasn't having it.
Ship off to Knobloch. Quickly ahead. Twos, gets it down low. Shot, no good. Rebound, fought for on the floor. Jays come away with it. Poked away, and we're going to have a foul. It's going to be on Ship off. That's going to be her first team's fourth of the quarter. Sorry, it's the third of the quarter. Sitzman, bounce pass it ahead to Larissa Poland. Poland weaves between the defenders, bounce pass to Schmidt. Sitzman, right side of the paint, dribble handoff to Larissa Poland. Defense has just been harassing the Jays all night as Schmidt tries to get it to Larissa Poland. It will remain Jays basketball with 15 left on the shot clock.
HMS has been all over the ball handler and then jumping passing lanes after that.
Lubin gets it into Zubrod. Zubrod kicks it right. Now I thought it was going back left immediately. Larissa Poland, and we're going to have a reach-in foul by Mariah Otto. That's going to be her first, team's fourth of the quarter. 1:25 left to go here in the second. Hoping Coach Wilchin will join us here for the halftime. Inbound to Sitzman. Sitzman with a left hand, now with a right. Kicks it out. Larissa Poland back to Sitzman. Sitzman being harassed beyond the arc. Gets a screen by Zubrod. Poland near the top of the key, and she draws Mariah Otto's second foul.
Second one quickly. And it is in the last minute.
And it is bonus time because five fouls gets you to bonus land. Larissa Poland go to the line to shoot two. Puts up the first with a right hand, and that one's good. Gets on the board with her first points of the game. Poland puts up the second, rattles around and out, no good. Rebound by Shipoff. Shipoff ahead to Monet. Quickly ahead, had a wide open three. Takes the three, does Shipoff, no good. Sitzman will bring it up the floor for the Jays. Just under a minute left to go. Coach Schecker slows the offense down. Sitzman between the legs dribble. Had Haley Poland open for a minute. Gets it out to Larissa Poland near the top of the key. Dribbles with her right hand toward the near side. Now back left. Bounce pass. Three from Schmidt. No good. Rebound is going to be... I'm just flabbergasted right now. Larissa Poland was... on the rebound, fell to the floor, and traveled with the basketball. She fell to the floor.
Had somebody on her back, another one that could have been over the back, but there was no contact there. That's just the height advantage for HMS. They're able to reach up and grab that without making much contact.
Poland able to come away with that overthrow, drives, kicks it over to Sitzman. If she had a little more power, she could have pulled the trigger on a three. Schmidt to Poland. Poland could have pulled the trigger there. Now 12 seconds left. Shot clock's off in the corner. Drives toward the paint, kicks it out. Sitzman, shot fake again. Haley Poland, Schmidt with three. Haley Poland, Sitzman, pulls the trigger on the three, no good. And the Jays trail this one at the half, 28-17. We'll be back in 1 minute to talk to Coach Wilchin. Back in 60, you're watching Fuller Digital Solutions and FullerDigital.net.
All the best sports shows, all the best games on 101.5 FM and 1570 AM for your college sports, University of South Dakota. For NHL coverage, Minnesota Wild. For NBA coverage, Minnesota Timberwolves. for MLB coverage, Chicago Cubs. And the best games in both college and the pros with the ESPN Radio featured games. Never miss out on the action.
Forget the ramps and hassles when hauling. They are built to tilt. Tilt Bed Trailers, made at Holstein Fabrication and Holstein Manufacturing.
We're excited to now offer one of the best tilt bed trailers on the market, ranging from 22 to 28 feet in length. And like everything we manufacture, these trailers are built to work, last, and make your life easier. Haul with confidence when you hook up to a tilt bed trailer made at Holstein Fabrication and Holstein Manufacturing. Visit us online today at HolsteinMFG.com.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling joined by Coach Ryan Wilchin. And Coach, you guys were victorious on Tuesday night versus HLP. Feels like forever ago, but a nice team victory as you really didn't let anybody jump out to any kind of too big of a scoring margin from HLP.
No, we didn't. We didn't, Matt. You know, we held the good guys, their good scores down to where kind of where we thought, but as a team, I was kind of hoping to hold them, you know, in that lower 40 range. We gave up 48. I was kind of hoping for a little better defensive night. We kind of let them back in the second quarter, or third quarter, that is. We gave them 15 points in the second. That's a little more than I like to give a team like that.
Yeah. It was a good shooting night for Carson Arns. Carson had 16 points on the night.
Yeah, Carson did a nice job inside. We've been working at practice on getting him the entry pass on time and in space, and the guys did a good job getting it to him. They pressed us early, and we broke the press very well, and we were able to get Carson some easy buckets, got him going, and then once he got in the half court, he kind of took it from there.
It was a good night over, you know, all around, and it was good to see Gabe get some good, solid playing time, kind of test that ankle out.
Yeah, he got a little bit of work. He was limited to 4 minutes a quarter. He was a little rusty coming back, but he did okay. It was good to get him back in a game like that.
Got to see Landon Ryder, and he played a very good game.
Landon had an excellent game. I talked to him the next day at practice. That's probably one of the best games he's had all year. His shot selection was perfect. Obviously, he shot well. I believe he was 5 for 6 or something like that. Only missed one shot. He was 2 for 2 from three, but he took good shots. Inside-out
yeah.
game.
Yeah. Can you talk a little bit, and maybe you've had it before, or maybe you've had it with siblings of yours, talk about the connection of having the Teal brothers on the floor. Do they have a little bit, and I don't want to say telepathic, but is it just kind of a look every once in a while where they just kind of know where they're going to be?
I'm not sure it's a good look all the time, Matt. to be honest, really honestly, I haven't really noticed much between those two. I mean, one's a sophomore, one's a senior, and I don't think they really played a whole lot together. To be honest with you, I can't really tell their brothers on the court. They don't interact too much. They handle it very well for brothers being the same team. Let's put it that way.
HMS is your opponent here tonight. You don't want to look at it as a, you know, you look at it and you say easy game. But with them not having a win coming into the ball game, how do you prevent the boys from coming out and saying, well, this team doesn't have a win, and overlooking them and looking at St. Mary's already?
That's a good question, Matt. We've talked about this in a couple of other games, about not worrying about the opponent, not worrying about the score, not worrying about the time. Just come out, play basketball, play hard every possession, and when the game's over, look up and see what you got. I'm anxious to see our maturity as a team this year. Because this is one of those trap games, you might say, to see how we handle this, come out and just play our style of basketball and not play to how they play or whatever, but just come out and play our game and play defense, come out with some intensity and set the tone.
You're almost hoping for the nameless, faceless opponent without the name on the jersey,
yep.
Kind of.
There you go.
Now, not looking too far ahead, but we don't get you before you guys take on St. Mary's. Talk a little bit about that St. Mary's team. They're still a good basketball team and family as far as coaching them.
Yep. The Rudens, they do a great job coaching over their players. They've been pretty consistent the last few years. Obviously, with Holman coming back, he'll be a challenge for us. I actually haven't watched him on game film yet. I kind of leave that up to Eric and Alex, so I'm sure tonight or tomorrow they'll be all over me with some scouting report on them. But I looked right before we came up. It seems like we're tied for the conference in the War Eagle, so we're both sitting right in the middle of the pack. I'm sure they're looking to break up and put, keep us down, so we'll try to fight back on that one.
Coach, I will let you be. Good luck tonight. Good luck on Tuesday night, and enjoy the rest over the Christmas break.
Thank you, Matt.
That's Coach Gabe Wilchin. Coach Ryan Wilchin. We'll be back with first half analysis of the girls' game. You're watching Fuller Digital Solutions.
Senior Lafferty Tuition Foundation awards tuition scholarships to students that attend a Catholic school in the Diocese of Sioux City. By contributing to MLTF, donors are eligible to receive a 75% tax credit from the state of Iowa. There is no other charitable gift that offers you a credit like that. It is also the perfect time of year to consider a gift of grain to MLTF. You can find more information about MLTF at scdiocese.org under the Giving tab. Please consider a gift to MLTF to give the gift of Catholic education.
Since the 1980s, Colbeck Incorporated has been a family-run business providing their customers with quality wood and feed grinding services throughout Northwest Iowa. Colbeck Incorporated knows that your time is valuable, and they pride themselves on getting the job done in a prompt and reliable fashion. Local cattle feeders have been relying on Colbeck Incorporated hay grinding for 30 years, and Brian and Kevin are proud of their partnerships they've built with their customers. Whether it's grinding, mulch, or hauling, call Colbeck Incorporated today and see what they can do for you.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling joined by Drew Bickford. Jays trail this one at half, 28-17. Jays lost the first quarter 16-10 and lost the second quarter by a score of 12-7.
It's going to be real important that Jays come out and bring some energy. The one thing with HMS, they're going to clog the lane. They have a lot of size. So sometimes it's driving it to the middle. If they're going to be in the zone, drive it to the middle, hit somebody with a baseline runner. But your shots are going to have to be quick. You're not going to be able to dribble drive and shoot something that's coming off 2 feet most likely. It's going to have to be a floater. It maybe have to pull up at the free throw line, but your release is going to have to be somewhat quick. And even for bigs, they move extremely well. So it's not like you can take them away from the rim and just take them off the dribble every time, because they move really well. So it's a tough task for the Jays to come back 11 in the second half.
It's difficult not having some of the size that the Jays could have on the floor tonight with Waljenbach being out and with Nevaeh Hodgson both being out in tonight's ballgame. Because Hodgson provides you both with some beef and with some height.
Yes, and she's not afraid to be physical down low. That's one thing. Haley Waljenbach, although just a freshman, one of the most physical players on the team. She was very, very, very scrappy and doesn't have really the body type of a freshman. Pretty well put together kid. And when she blew her knee out, that was a pretty big, not necessarily points, but she was averaging over six rebounds a game. And just the physicality in the length, really long arms. It'll be exciting when she comes back next year. But, a big loss for this year. And Nevaeh, hopefully this is just a one-game thing, and she's ready to roll when their next game.
Again, St. Mary's, that'll be Tuesday night. You can catch that on the Remsen St. Mary's Fuller Digital Solutions channel. Of course, the two Catholic schools, rivals, just down the road from each other. Reminder, the Monsignor Lafferty Tuition Foundation campaign is underway. 75% State of Iowa tax credit on that donation. That one's a pretty good chunk if you make that donation. So if you're interested, make sure you contact Amy before the new year so you can get that donation in. Of course, grain is accepted in addition to cash, but make sure you reach out for that donation. Friends of Gehlen Catholic Ball is going to be on Saturday, April 20th. This year's theme is A Night in Nashville. It's always a good time. One of the biggest things that's up for auction is naming rights on this gym. There are also, I know, parking spaces available. I think pews at the Holiday are up for grabs. A lot of different items. And I have come away with some one-of-one items from classrooms. They're always great items there, Drew.
There's always really cool items at the Gehlen Ball. And I remember one year they sold a scoreboard. Would have been really cool. My wife wasn't having it, but it looked really cool. just different opportunities, different items.
I think the Yoakums came away with the old gym mats from here, the end gym mats there for their gymnasium.
Cool decorations for the basement if your wife would allow it.
As we get started with the second half, ball kicked over to Shipoff, top of the key, Mone, three, off the back iron, no good, rebound by Sitzman. Sitzman will bring it ahead over the timeline with the left hand, now between the legs dribble, drives into the paint, puts up a right hand, that one is blocked. She's able to get her own rebound, and that one is tipped out of bounds by Shipoff.
Isaiah did a good job driving the lane, but she really didn't seek out the contact until she was going up. And at that point, the tall HMS girls down low, are they ready to leave their feet. You have to get the contact earlier to kind of knock them off balance.
Sitzman puts up a floater. No good. It's going to be – ooh, I thought that for sure was off of Schmidt, but it must have been a reach by the Hawks to knock it out of bounds. 7:31 left to go here in the quarter. Ball inbounded for a half a second off a ship off back out of bounds.
Isaiah just got lucky there. That was got away with a moving screen.
Schmidt, bounce pass in, fought for. It's going to be a foul on the play. Just a matter of if it's Dahmer or Otto. Ooh, they called that on ship off. Schilling is wrong. Zubrod catches the inbound. Sitzman pulls the trigger on a three. Knocks it down. 11 for her now. 28-20. That's going to be out of bounds off the Hawks. I believe that was off of Otto.
That's the majority of their turnovers from HMS. That pass over the top coming off the hands are either just a little too long or coming off the hands of the big trying to receive the pass.
Sitzman with the inbound. Gets it ahead to Grace Callen. Sorry about this, folks. I know you're watching at home, and I have clearly fallen asleep at the wheel on you here. It's the rebound by the Hawks. Grace Kellen tries to save that one from going out of bounds, is not able to.
Got lucky there. As a coach, you're always going to tell your players, don't save the ball under the opponent's hoop. More often than not, you're going to save it right to somebody for a layup.
Three, ship off, no good, rebound, fought for, and we're going to have a reach in. Reach by Knoblock, that's her first, team second of the quarter, and early fouls here by HMS. Sitzman with a left hand. Hawk showing press, quickly ahead. To Poland, Haley puts up a shot. It's going to be off of HMS, out of bounds. Remain Jays basketball.
So far, that 1-3-1 press hasn't really given the Jays much problem.
Inbound to Zubrod. Zubrod hands it off to Sitzman. Sitzman around the top of the key. Haley Poland to Schmidt. Schmidt to Zubrod. Zubrod double team. Kicks it out to Kellen in the far corner. Back out to Schmidt with eight left on the shot clock. Poland to Sitzman. She's going to need to pull the trigger on something. Zubrod spins, three, shot block. Poland puts that one up, and that one was blocked as time runs out on the play clock.
So the ball moved that possession. The players did not. A lot of passing and kind of V-cutting in and out. So really no movement player-wise, and maybe that was to get Zubrod the ball down low, but not a lot of movement body-wise.
Down low, a lot of contact, corner. Bench wanted her to shoot it. Shipoff puts that one up. It rattles around and down. Shipoff now, according to me, has nine. Hawks have 31. That one out of bounds will go over to the Hawks.
The exciting thing about tonight, for everybody but the group that has to clean up the gym, free popcorn night. Always a favorite when you get the free popcorn, unless you're the group that has to clean up tonight.
I think my kids always end up on a cleanup night like that. In the corner, Knoblock, near side. dribbles out of it. Cross court, it's going to be out of bounds. It will be Jay's basketball. 5:22 left to go in the quarter. Pulling in for Schmidt. And what have we got, a timeout? Full timeout. Hey, let's take it with them. Back in 60 seconds, you're watching Fuller Digital Solutions.
Whether you are combining, hauling grain, or heating your home, fuel powers the fall. When it comes to energy, you need a company who is trustworthy, understands your needs, and who delivers to you. A company who is local, reliable, and affordable. That company is Ag State. Ag State Energy is clean, comfortable, convenient, while staying competitively priced for our customers. Give Laura Sanguin or Seth Duff a call for all your energy needs.
MHI and Cuso of Cherokee are on the move, expanding, and in need of residential treatment workers, psychiatric security specialists, and LPNs.
We deal with disorders that you can't see. You get to help people who are in desperate need of help. And helping those people actually helps the community as well.
The benefits here, I think, are top-notch. That was why I came here.
To learn more and to apply, visit governmentjobs.com.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling joined by Drew Bickford. And Drew, what's it going to take to get Sitzman to get some more shots off here?
Well, really, the Knobloch has been doing a really good job sticking to her hip and not giving her much space. It's really going to take somebody else to get hot to maybe free up some space for Isaiah. Jays don't score a ton of points offensively. Nevaeh was their second leading scorer at just over 6 points per game. So she's a bigger loss than 6 points per game. Doesn't sound like a ton, but when it's your second leading scorer, that's a big deal.
Ship off that one, no good. Reach over the top. Again, another reach over the top, put back by Dama. She now has six, 32-20. Sorry, 33-20. I can't do math. We're going to have a foul as we try to come across the timeline. Foul's going to be on two. That's Gracie Knobloch. That's going to be her second, team's third. We're going to see a duo of Hawks come into the ballgame as Coach Schecker gets an explanation on the sideline. Sitzman kicks it right to Pullen, back to Sitzman, pulls the trigger on a three, no good, rebound, fought for, and we're going to have a held ball. It will be Jay's basketball. 4:43 to go left in the third.
I think these last 4.5 minutes, the Jays have to close it within, they have to get it within single digits going into the fourth.
Sitzman, the inbounder, bounce pass into Kellen. Kellen swarmed. Zubrod tries to get it down low, loses control of the basketball, and the Jays are on the floor. It's going to be off of a diving Larissa Pullen, and it will be Hawks basketball.
I thought we might see Bella tonight. Bella just moved up to Varsity. A lot of size, but a lot of improvement from last year to this year, so kind of excited to see how she moves pretty well and just very tall.
Three from Eliza Twos. She now has five. Bella with it now. Larissa Pullen thought she could have pulled the trigger on that one. Instead, Grace Kellen pulls the trigger. No good. Rebound by Shipoff. Jay's last time down showed a zone type of pressure, and we're going to have a foul on the shot. It's going to be on Haley Pullen. Pullen commits the foul and will send Twos to the line to shoot two. First one off the back iron, no good. Second free throw attempt is up, rattles around some more, rebound by the Hawks, no good. Bella Schrader comes away with it, and Kellen brings it up the floor. Kellen into the paint, puts up a layup, caught the basket, and the foul for Grace Kellen.
Boy, she missed a wide open. Larissa Pullen coming down the right side of the court, but got the and one instead.
foul is going to be on Mariah Otto. That's her third. Team's fourth. Kellen, no good. Rebound, fought for. It's going to be off of Kellen to the Hawks. Not able to finish off that three-point play. Ball inbounded to Shipoff. Shipoff brings it up over the timeline. Stops. Floats it over the top. Grace Kellen able to swat it away. Grace tries to put up a shot, and she is fouled by Shipoff, who does not stop her feet.
Grace did a good job of drawing contact there. Picks up Shipoff's third foul.
Coach Kellen's holding up the wall over there, and I thought I saw a little smile off of him as she took the foul. First shot is no good. Kellen will get one more. Thanks to Ag State for sponsoring tonight's scoreboard. Schuster Trucking for bringing you tonight's bottom line. Second free throw attempt, no good, and we got a free throw lane violation by Abby Dalma. Kellen will get another shot at it. That one, no good. Rebound by Dalma. Dalma hands it to Monet. Kicks it over to Scheller. Down low, puts up the shot. No good. Jurgensen tries it. She puts up a block. And Sitzman is carrying the basketball. Real choppy second half here. A lot of stoppages in play. Hello to Jeff. Jeff, I don't know where you're at today. I know you're in Illinois for a while. His three-point attempt is knocked down by Lindsey Van Ness. She now has five. Jeff, I don't know if you're in Illinois or if you travel back to Indiana tonight as Sitzman brings it up the floor. Bounce pass over to Bella. Gets it in the paint. Larissa puts up a hard shot, no good. Grace Kellen comes away with a rebound. Sitzman drives, puts it up in the paint. Left hand, no good. Rebound fought for, stolen away. Larissa Poland, bounce pass in. Schrader, no good. And Dalma comes away with it, and the Hawks send it around. As Moni comes, throws it up top to Van Ness. Wide open, 18 foot, no good. Rebound fought for, put back, in and out, no good. Van Ness Scheller is fouled. She pops back up. Foul is going to be on 32. That's Larissa Poland. That's her first, team second, and it's a shooting foul. Sending Addison Scheller to the line to shoot two. First one is up and good.
Her first point of the game. Ever since Bella Schrader came in, they kind of went to a 2-3, letting Bella kind of control the paint. Bella's come a long way, and I'm really excited to see what the next couple of years bring for her. Physicality is something that I would die for my daughter to have that size and that height. She just needs to learn to use that physically, and I think we'll see that over the next couple of years.
Sitzman with a right hand. Paulson tries to get it down low to Zubrod. Sammy tries to put up a shot, no good. Off of the tip, it'll be Jay's basketball on the baseline. Sitzman gets it into Zubrod, hands it off to Sitzman near the top of the key, drives left side of the paint, puts up a Euro step, no good. Zubrod with a putback and in. Sammy Zubrod has two. Knob block, and we're going to have a 30-second timeout. Back in 30, you're watching Jason Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions and FullerDigital.net.
Lloyd Valley Healthcare, we want you to travel somewhere fun, not to a doctor's appointment. Specialists, specialty clinics, and outpatient services bring advanced skills and training and make diagnostics and treatment capabilities more accessible, keeping care convenient and close to home. Working in step with your healthcare team, specialists communicate and collaborate to provide you and your family the care that you need. To learn more about specialty services, talk with your provider or visit floydvalley.org.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling and Drew Bickford here tonight. Appreciate Drew for joining us here tonight.
It's been a while, so I'm glad to be back.
Hawks with a 16-point lead. His ball's inbounded to Knobloch. Knobloch between the circles, gets it down low. That one is going to be poked out of the hands of Van Ness, out of bounds. It will remain Hawks basketball.
Gehlen switching to a 1-3-1, it looks like. That's, I think Brandon's got a go-to zone offense.
Scheller inbounds the basketball. Knobloch gets a cutter. Van Ness down low, fought for, gets her own rebound, and we're going to have a tie-up. It will remain Hawks basketball underneath the basket. I think I see your child heading to get some free popcorn. I think he's just going to dump it all over the bleachers, isn't he?
Probably candy.
Oh, okay. Three attempt, no good off the front iron. Gets her own rebound. Puts up a long two, no good. Rebound by Sitzman. Sitzman has numbers. Gets around Knobloch. Left side of the paint. Puts it up and in. Isaiah Sitzman now with 13. 40-26. As Knobloch brings it up the floor. See the obvious height advantage on now with a two, no good. Put back, no good. Rebound is twos, and we're going to have a foul. I believe it's going to be on Sitzman. Nope, they're going to call it on Zubrod.
That's her third. They gave them into a 2-3, and they're really packing in the paint. And HMS has been more than happy to take the mid-range jumpers. Just haven't knocked them down yet.
Quick inbound. Shot, no good. Rebound by Lubin. Lubin kicks it up the court. And Sitzman is fouled there by Knobloch. That'll be Knobloch's third. She was a little wobbly. I think it was just more of the aftershock of the hit.
Yeah, a little hip to hip.
Sitzman will go to the line to two for two as it's the fifth team foul with just under 60 ticks. Sitzman bends the knees, puts it up and in. 14 points for Sitzman. Brings the lead down to 13. Second is in the air and good. Quickly ahead is Mone. Three-point attempt, no good. Rebound by the Hawks. Second point attempt, these second point chances are kind of killing the Jays as that one's off of Paulson.
I'm going to guess HMS is going to talk about maybe not settling for jumpers at the end of the third quarter. But the tough part about when you're playing a zone is who do you box out? And the key is anybody you can find. And right now, Gehlen not really finding anybody to box out.
Sitzman inbound to Poland, back to Sitzman, who brings it up over the timeline. Sitzman kicks it out. Three-point fender. That missile off the backboard, no good. Rebound by twos. Knobloch will bring it up for the Hawks. Down low, size advantage, and Zubrod is going to pick up her fourth as Dalmo went up.
Well, she was in perfect position. At the last second, she decided, well, I'm going to block this, and arms came down, and as a ref, you see the arms come down. Whether it's clean or not, more often than not, you're going to blow the whistle.
First free throw attempt is up and in from Dalmo. She now has seven on the night. Zubrado go out, and who else is going out? Sitzman, Larissa Poland comes in, Schmidt comes in. Second free throw attempt, high arcing, no good. It's going to be off the Hawks. It will be Jays basketball with 22.8 left to go in the third. Jays down by 13. Paulson in the corner. Thought she could have pulled the trigger on it. Larissa Poland, bounce pass to Fender. Fender back to Lubin. Paulson, three, no good. Rebound by Dalma. Ahead to Mone. Mone
three at the buzzer off the side of the backboard. No good. Jays trail this one 41-28. We'll be back with the fourth quarter. You're watching Jays and Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions and FullerDigital.net.
Whether you are combining, hauling grain, or heating your home, fuel powers the fall. When it comes to energy, you need a company who is trustworthy, understands your needs, and who delivers to you. A company who is local, reliable, and affordable. That company is Ag State. Ag State Energy is clean, comfortable, convenient, while staying competitively priced for our customers. Give Laura Sanguin or Seth Duff a call for all your energy needs.
MHI and Cuso of Cherokee are on the move, expanding, and in need of residential treatment workers, psychiatric security specialists, and LPNs.
We deal with disorders that you can't see. You get to help people who are in desperate need of help. And helping those people actually helps the community as well.
The benefits here, I think, are top-notch. That was why I came here.
To learn more and to apply, visit governmentjobs.com.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling and Drew Bickford as we get ready to start this fourth quarter. Ball inbounded to Sitzman. Sitzman with the left hand, drives with the right, spins back with the left, puts up a floater off the backboard. No good. Paulson with the putback and in. Kennedy Paulson with her first 2 points of the ball game. It's down to an 11-point deficit for the Jays. Corner, Mone. That one's stolen away by Larissa Poland. Larissa has two trailers. Left-handed layup, no good. Not her natural hand. And Shipoff is fouled in the backcourt.
Looked like she wanted to get back to the right hand, but the defense wasn't going to allow it. Kennedy Paulson is actually a player that didn't really start playing, getting varsity minutes until probably 3-4 games ago. She's shooting right around 50% from three-point range. Doesn't take a lot of them, but probably somebody you're willing to let shoot a little bit more as her coach. She's put in some good minutes.
Nice job coming away with the rebound at Paulson. Quickly ahead. Fender. Layup is good.
Great pass.
J.C. Fender found the touch. It's 32-41. Shipoff. Now top of the key. Mone back to Shipoff. She ships off a three for good. She now has 13.
Her third three of the game.
Sitzman to Poland, pulls the trigger on a three, top of the key, no good. Mone with the rebound. Mone kicks it up ahead, ship off, gets it down low, puts it up and in, does Otto.
Jays finally closed within single digits, and right away, 5-0 run by HMS.
Schmidt to Larissa Poland. Poland guarded heavily by Otto. Paulson to Fender. Fender gets it over to Sitzman. Sitzman with a left hand. Fouled right around the free throw line.
Kind of bailed out there. Offense a little bit stagnant right there. Not a lot of movement.
Gracie Knobloch with the foul, and we'll see Bella Schrader come back into the ballgame. I thought she played well to start her varsity career.
Yes, she did. She gave some good minutes. If she learns to be physical, boy, she could give some really big minutes then.
Sitzman gets it into Schmidt. Schmidt hands it back off to Sitzman. Sitzman with the left hand, left side of the paint, and she is slapped hard there. I think that was on Mone. It was. That's going to be her first, team second, and it's going to send Sitzman to the line to shoot two. You know, one thing, Drew, that we've seen is out of J.C. Fender, we've seen probably three or four missiles go at the backboard. What do you do as a coach to try to coach that out of a player?
Some of that's going to be technique. Some of it's touch. Some of it's just getting shots up, which I can tell you, knowing that family, I'm sure she gets a lot of shots up. But some of it is maybe she's pushing rather than kind of pushing up. She's pushing towards the hoop. So a lot of it's repetition. But some of it could have to do with form, too. I'm sure we'll see that improve as she moves forward.
And some of it may be a little bit of panic when she gets that open shot. Kind of mechanics go away.
Mone gets it down low. Spotted up a three. Puts up the shot. No good. Rebound. Fought for. And we're going to have a tie-up under the hoop.
Ever since Bella came in, she's been doing a good job at just getting big, putting her arms up.
I say this in the best possible way. She's wreaking havoc.
Yes, she is.
Mone with it in the near corner. Kicks it across to twos. Quickly pulls the trigger. No good. Put back. No good. Fought for. Mone comes away with it. Twos pulls the trigger on another one. No good. Jays give up a lot of second chance opportunities. Hawks not able to cash in as Sitzman tries to go coast to coast. No good.
Good
Bella puts
right
up
there.
The shot.
Way
she
to run
is
the court.
Fouled. Talk a little bit about her size, but she was able to get some hustle down the floor. It's going to be the third team foul, and it's going to be the first on Abby Dama.
Sometimes when the games haven't been going your way and the end of the game, you lose by a few points. You lose by a few points, and sometimes as it goes on, it's tough to maybe get some of those hustle plays because you're mentally starting to check out a little bit. And that was great hustle running the court right there, running down, not taking for granted that Rize is going to make the layup.
Bella Schrader 1-for-2 at the line. Down low, Dalma kicks it back out. Three, no good. That might be the first misstep from Shipoff tonight. As Kellen will come into the ball game. Kellen's going to send Sitzman to the bench, and we're going to take a full timeout. Back in 60 on Fuller.
Staying healthy means enjoying life's best moments. And the best way to stay healthy is to make your routine appointments. Whether you have new symptoms or it's time for your annual exam, the providers at Floyd Valley Healthcare know and listen to you, so you'll get the care that you need. We help you stay healthy by providing preventative care, finding health concerns early, managing chronic conditions, and connecting you with specialty care close to home. Don't miss a single special moment. Make your appointment today.
When it's time to choose a bank, the choice is easy. Prime Bank is the bank for you.
With all the conveniences you want in a bank, including a mobile app and online account opening, Prime Bank also offers you-pick checking with no monthly fees or minimum balances. And the best part is, you get paid for everyday banking transactions. That's right. Prime Bank's you-pick checking. We pay you for your everyday checking account transactions.
Choose Prime Bank. It's the bank for you. Earn more your way with Prime Bank.
Member FDIC.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford. Sitzman stays in the ball game, and she brings it up the floor for the Jays. With a left hand, hands it off to Grace Kellen. Kellen, dribble drive, puts it up. No good. Rebound by Dalma. Quickly up the floor is Mone. Cross-court pass. Ship off. Gets it down low. Puts up the shot. No good. Rebound by the Jays. Sitzman ahead. Has Fender ahead. Kicks it to Fender. Puts it up. And that one swatted away by the Hawks.
That swat was with authority.
Quickly ahead. Shot. Put up. Don't count the basket, but do count the foul. And it'll send Otto to the line to shoot two. Second team foul by the Jays. It's the third on Emerson Schmidt. Mariah just looks so much taller than 6 foot out there as that one rattles off the back iron and backboard and out. Hello to my family at home watching tonight. I know I think I've got a couple of children here. Second free throw is up off the front iron. No good. Bella fights for it. Ahead, the Jays come away with it. Sitzman with it now. Over to Fender. Back to Sitzman. Poked away. Sitzman puts up a floating left hand. No good. Rebound by Otto.
One thing I noticed for the Jays, every time they drive, they've shot almost every time. Some of that is when you drive and you bring the help on defense, somebody else is open, so hit them with a bounce pass. But right now, they've got that mindset when they drive, they're looking to score. Kind of the same mindset I'm struggling with my fourth grade boys with yet. Still just haven't grown to that level yet.
Sitzman will be the inbounder. Or she'll bring it up the floor, I'm sorry. little bit of an off night for myself. Sitzman near the top of the key. Now with the right hand. Kellen quickly over to Fender. Fender down low, tries to get it. They're going to say it's off of Bella Schrader. I wasn't so sure it wasn't off of Damo, but I don't have the best look from about 105 feet away. We got to do something about that horn, Drew. Can you do something about that?
Do you know who the IT person is here? Or?
I don't think that's an IT issue. Sounds electrical to me. Shipoff inbounds the basketball to Van Ness. Van Ness back to Shipoff. Van Ness near the top of the key, kicks it right, twos, back over. Now Van Ness. They're just a triangle pass right now. That's all it is. Jay is showing the 2-3 zone. Gets it down low, puts up the layup and in from twos.
Two's got the bucket, but Otto got the assist by sealing off the lane and giving her a little jumper.
Zubrod puts up that layup. Sammy was just standing right there, willing and able. It's 46-38, and we're going to have a foul off the ball on Schmidt. And that's going to be Schmidt's fourth personal. We'll see a pair of subs come into the ballgame. 2:54 left to go in this ballgame. Quick trigger, ship off, in and out, rattles, no good. Rebound Van S, and she's going to go to the line to shoot two as she is fouled by Haley Lubin.
Boy, as a J, you're extremely happy to see that quick trigger at the three, but you got to get that rebound once that shot goes up.
Got a lot of bodies under the hoop and just not taking advantage of getting that rebound as the first one rattles out.
Just standing at the at the free throw line, the size discrepancy is pretty obvious.
Yeah. Hello to the Kurth family at home as the second free throw attempt goes up. Of course, Coach Marty Kurth. Appreciate you watching tonight. Grace Kellen drives, puts up the shot, and that one's just blocked. I want to make the pun of a block party, but I don't know if it's appropriate. I don't remember the Jays playing all these big bodies, and I don't know the they played them in volleyball here as a floater from Sitzman is no good, fought for, and Haley Poland commits the foul. It's going to be her second.
You have to get Marty Kurth up here sometime just to talk with you.
We could spin some yarn.
One of the great coaches from Gehlen. Always fun to listen to.
And he's got all of the stories, too. Between stories on baseball.
I remember as a kid coaching baseball, coaching with Fox, I believe, on basketball.
And all the stories he has about Coach Meyer. Hello to Coach Meyer watching up in Orange City tonight. Second free throw attempt off the back iron. No good. Rebound. Fought for. Come away with by Knobloch. I wasn't so sure that Shipoff wasn't going to ship one off from deep there. Zubrod steals that one away, gets it over to Sitzman. Sitzman brings it up the floor for the Jays, pushes off just a little bit with that left hand. Corner three, Haley Poland off the side of the backboard, no good. I think she was trying to just cut the cheese just a little bit there, as that one's going to be off of the Hawks and out of bounds.
Jays are going to have to get some quick shots up. First shot that looks good, take it. Don't have time to pass the ball around too much right now.
Sitzman, top of the key, gets a screen, step back, gets it down to Zubrod. Zubrod tries to put up a shot, no foul. It's going to be out of bounds. She just comes away laughing, shaking her head.
I thought Isaiah might pull that three. Said we took the option to throw it in and challenge the bigs.
I think the sixth grade team you coach, or seventh grade team that you coach, has somebody that would just pull the trigger on that. Sitzman with it now, beyond the arc, pulls the trigger, in and out, no good. Rebound, Lubin with the shot, and rattles around and down. Haley Lubin with eight. It's 39-48.
Risky pass.
They're going to say that Zubrod was on the baseline. It's going to be out of bounds to the Hawks.
Really surprised we didn't see some heavy pressure from the Jays right now. We need some turnovers.
1:27 left to go. Quick shot off the back iron and good for Shipoff. Three rattles around and down. And a timeout. We'll take a full timeout. Back in 60 on Fuller.
Catholic in Lamar's, Iowa instills respect and Christian values in a caring environment for students preschool through 12th grade. Teachers and staff go above and beyond to provide a high quality education and are dedicated to student success. We are a community striving to live God's word each day through academics, service opportunities, athletics, and so much more. Gehlen Catholic School, in partnership with Spalding Catholic School, all are welcome to experience excellence in education and leadership through Christ.
Sitzman Construction, Lamar's, general contractors you can trust with the job you need done, when you need it done. Call Jeremy at Sitzman Construction when you need a remodel or a complete build. And they work with EPS buildings. Jeremy takes the time to know what you need. Past clients say he's reliable, honest, fair-minded, and reasonably priced. Contact Jeremy at Sitzman Construction. Jeremy and his crew will satisfy all of your construction needs. 712-540-2731.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford. Hawks bring the ball up the floor. Monet passes to Shipoff. Shipoff gets it down low. Ball fought for, and Otto was mugged. She will go to the line to shoot two as the Hawks are in the bonus. Puts up the first and knocks it down to Zotto. And she now has 16. It's 51-39. Second one off the front iron, no good. Rebound, pushed ahead. Sitzman with it now, just under a minute to go. Top of the key, three. Grace Sitzman off the backboard and back iron, no good. 13-second shot clock to game clock. Knobloch with it, gets it down low, puts up the bunny and good for Otto. Otto now with 18. Sitzman, jumper at the free throw line, no good. Rebound by Dalma, and we're going to have a fought for possession. Jays trapping in the backcourt, and we're going to have a timeout by the Hawks.
Just in the nick of time.
30 seconds, see you in 30 on Fuller.
Senior Lafferty Tuition Foundation awards tuition scholarships to students that attend a Catholic school in the Diocese of Sioux City. By contributing to MLTF, donors are eligible to receive a 75% tax credit from the state of Iowa. There is no other charitable gift that offers you a credit like that. It is also the perfect time of year to consider a gift of grain to MLTF. You can find more information about MLTF at scdiocese.org under the Giving tab. Please consider a gift to MLTF to give the gift of Catholic education.
There's rumors that Iowa's hiring.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford. 20.1 left to go here in the fourth. Jays trail by 11. Hawks to inbound the basketball from the boundary. Put it in the front court. Shipoff drives toward the basket. Puts up a layup, up and in. She now has 17. Three-point attempt from Sitzman, no good. Rebound by Zubrod, shot blocked as time expires. The Hawks win this one 55-42. We will take a one-minute break and be back. You're watching Jays and Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions and FullerDigital.net.
All the best sports shows, all the best games on 101.5 FM and 1570 AM for your college sports, University of South Dakota. For NHL coverage, Minnesota Wild. For NBA coverage, Minnesota Timberwolves. For MLB coverage, Chicago Cubs. And the best games in both college and the pros with the ESPN Radio featured games. Never miss out on the action.
Forget the ramps and hassles when hauling. They are built to tilt. Tilt Bed Trailers, made at Holstein Fabrication and Holstein Manufacturing.
We're excited to now offer one of the best tilt bed trailers on the market, ranging from 22 to 28 feet in length. And like everything we manufacture, these trailers are built to work, last, and make your life easier. Haul with confidence when you hook up to a tilt bed trailer made at Holstein Fabrication and Holstein Manufacturing. Visit us online today at HolsteinMFG.com.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford. And Drew, the Jays dropped that one by a score of 55 to 42. As we take a look at some of the stats, go ahead, why don't you rattle off some of them here.
Scoring for HMS, the three-headed monster down low of Chipoff, Numa, and Otto. Abby not quite as, she was averaging 11 a game, only 7 tonight, but the other two picked it up. Otto was only averaging 12, but had 18, and Chipoff had averaging 11 and had 17. So those three, almost the majority of the scoring, as we kind of expected with the size discrepancy. Every quarter, the Jays got behind a few more points every quarter and just couldn't quite close it. Got to single digits in the fourth, but then just couldn't get any closer.
A lot of just small runs, and by small, I'm talking 5-6 point runs, but it was just enough where it was 6-2, 6-2, and that seems to kind of does the trick to death by a thousand paper cuts.
Yes, they when a team is averaging in the 40s for points per game, a 5-6-0 run is a lot more than say a team that's averaging 70 or 80. A 5-0-6-0 run then is not that big a deal. But when offense isn't your strength, any run at all can cost you.
Scoring tonight looked like this from the Hawks. Lindsey Van Ness had 5. Addison Scheller had 2. Eliza Tews had 7. Kylie Chipoff, as you said, was 17. Abby Dalma had 7. And Mariah Otto led all scorers with 18. For the Jays, Grace Kellen, nice performance with 5. Rizea with 16. Haley Lubin had 8. J.C. Fender had 2. Kennedy Paulson with 2. Larissa Poland had 1 at the stripe. Samantha Zubrod had 4. And Bella Schrader had 1. A little bit of a disappointing night. It sees the Hawks draw back to even. They're back at 500 with a 4-4 record. And it drops the Jays down to 1-10 on the season. And it doesn't get any easier as the Jays travel on Tuesday night to play Remsen St. Mary's.
Remsen St. Mary's, a really good squad. And really for Remsen St. Mary's, I think a very seasoned squad as well. Some players that have been around a few years now. For the Jays, just another one that wasn't out of control. I mean, they were within 10 almost the whole game, just really never got much closer than that. And just couldn't quite, they got it to 8-9, I believe, at one point, and then 5-0 run by HMS, and it's back to 14. Then it takes quite a while to get back to 10, and then HMS would hit a 3 or hit a couple buckets. Defense would be really, really solid, then all of a sudden you have a possession or two where in a 1-3-1 or in a 2-3, the back end gets too far forward, and there's some throws over the top for layups.
The Hawks have a tough road. Not only the Jays have a tough road, the Hawks have a tough road as they head up, and the girls do, up to George Little Rock on next Tuesday, as George Little Rock's 5-0 on the season, and the change of conference, change of scenery has been a good thing for the Mustangs. So
this HMS team will be a fun team to kind of watch next year. All three that we mentioned for the top scoring for HMS today will be back next year. They will still have plenty of size, and
they'll be a scary team.
Yes, they just so much size, especially for a smaller school. That's a tough matchup when you can bring three girls that are 6 foot or around 6 foot, and throw them in and out or have them in at the same time. That makes it tough to match up, regardless of what kind of style of basketball you play, because they aren't. If you look at a lineup in a 1A school and you see they have a few 6 footers, you're thinking, let's get out and run. The problem is, these girls from HMS can run with you. They're not your prototypical like 6'1" bigs you'll see in 1A that maybe don't move quite as well. These girls can move.
We will take a break and we'll come back to talk more after this. You're watching Jays and Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions and FullerDigital.net.
Senior Lafferty Tuition Foundation awards tuition scholarships to students that attend a Catholic school in the Diocese of Sioux City. By contributing to MLTF, donors are eligible to receive a 75% tax credit from the state of Iowa. There is no other charitable gift that offers you a credit like that. It is also the perfect time of year to consider a gift of grain to MLTF. You can find more information about MLTF at scdiocese.org under the Giving tab. Please consider a gift to MLTF to give the gift of Catholic education.
Since the 1980s, Colbeck Incorporated has been a family-run business providing their customers with quality wood and feed grinding services throughout Northwest Iowa. Colbeck Incorporated knows that your time is valuable, and they pride themselves on getting the job done in a prompt and reliable fashion. Local cattle feeders have been relying on Colbeck Incorporated hay grinding for 30 years, and Brian and Kevin are proud of their partnerships they've built with their customers. Whether it's grinding, mulch, or hauling, call Colbeck Incorporated today and see what they can do for you.
Picture. Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford. And we get ready to take a look at these two boys' teams. And it will be quite the matchup. Like we talked about with Coach Wilchin, just hoping the Jays aren't overlooking the Hawks tonight. The Hawks are 0-6 on the season, while the Jays are 3-4. Jays have had an impressive last couple of victories here, finding a little bit of rhythm. The Hawks, like we said, not finding a win yet this season. A younger team, Van Beek looks to be, and Vargas are, and Pearson, so three seniors. So about average, but everybody else is a fairly young on this HMS squad.
Yeah, HMS doesn't really have anybody that really sticks out as far as like points per game. They have a few people that average about 6 per game. So no go-to score necessarily. Only averaging 28.2 points per game. So defense is going to be a huge thing for HMS. One thing that you've seen with Gehlen this year, they don't have the – last year they had 2,000-point scores, or that was a couple years ago, I guess. But you had the Gehlen all-time leading scorer last year, and offense was not an issue. It seemed like when we got beat, it was defensively some breakdowns or maybe a big post that we didn't have a good matchup on. This year, we don't really have a go-to score. And instead, Gabe Wilson's back, and he's done a good job kind of filling the top scorer role. But we don't have a go-to like we did last year. But the biggest difference this year, I'd say, everybody's connected on the defensive end. Defense is such a huge thing, whether you're in man-to-man or zone. Everybody's got to be on the same page when it comes to help defense or how the zone moves. And these guys really seem connected and move really well on defense. A lot of energy. They don't take plays off. And that's credit to Coach Wilchin, really having these guys locked in on the defensive end.
It's been interesting to see how Coach Wilson's philosophies toward some of the, I don't know what you want to call them, the intangible things, the when you take a timeout, the when you're going to press. It's been interesting to see how that has played out so far this season.
Yeah. One thing I will say, the Jays early on in a few games, not as bad the last two games, and maybe that's why we've seen them kind of take off. But early on in the season, they tend to settle for outside jumpers, three-point jumpers. And they do have some decent shooters from the outside, but live by the three, die by the three. Doesn't always go your way. You're going to lose to teams that you shouldn't. You might beat some teams you shouldn't. But as of late, they have some decent size down low. Carson Arns has been I've seen him play the last few years. This is his first varsity action this year. He is very, very, very fundamentally sound. He does not make a lot of mistakes. He doesn't turn the ball over much. He's 6'5", but plays bigger than 6'5". Blocks, I don't know how many blocks per game he averages, but it's got to be a few. He's just kind of big fundamental down low, and that's really – Gehlen really hasn't had somebody that's been a big down low necessarily that is a true post. So that's kind of neat to see that we have somebody kind of just a sophomore, so a few more years coming. And then some pieces around him. Gabe Wilchin, we know, is pretty banged up. So other guys have really jumped into roles that maybe they weren't expecting. It'll be interesting to see. I don't know. I like shooting, but I guess I'm a high-maintenance shooter because I don't know how he continues to shoot so well with that big brace on his hand. But he continues to shoot well.
Shooters shoot, and you take shots, and you practice the shots whether you got the brace on or not. So we will take another timeout and be back after this. You're watching Jays and Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions and FullerDigital.net.
AgriVision Equipment and ExactEmerge Planter Technology is here to help you maximize your yield and efficiency, along with a proven 8 bushel per acre yield advantage because of the pinpoint accuracy of seed depth and placement. You can cover 50 acres per hour without compromising your stand. We know the risk of planting outside the optimal planting window, so don't let the weather control your bottom line. When you partner with AgriVision Equipment, you get access to the best service and technology support in the area. And visit any one of our 15 locations today to learn more about our large selection of new and used planters. AgriVision Equipment, focused on your future.
Reliance means being dependable. And when it comes to comfort in your home, you want Reliance from a place you can trust with a product you can count on. That's why Marcus Lumber stocks Reliance brand water heaters. Because with Reliance in the name, it's the brand you can trust. Marcus Lumber has been stocking and installing Reliance water heaters for decades. So choose the name you trust for your home. Choose Marcus Lumber and Reliance water heaters.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym, and we talk about some Gehlen business going on and actually some Catholic schools business that's going on. There is now a raffle, Drew, for a $50,000 vehicle voucher for Rick Collins Toyota and for Knepfler Chevrolet. It's one voucher for one of the dealerships. It is a $50,000 voucher. You must be an Iowa resident or business, 18 or over. You are responsible for tax, title, license, and registration, not to mention insurance. But a $100 raffle ticket gets you the opportunity to win. It is amongst all 16 diocesan schools, so make sure you check that out. You can contact Amy Jungers in the development office for a ticket. $100 for $50,000? That's not a bad trade-off, is it, Drew?
Seems like a drop in the bucket.
You know what it sounds like? It sounds like a Jay Bickford buy. He's just got that. He's gotten that in the couch cushions, right?
Probably time for a new car.
I think so. I don't know if he'll find anything he likes at those dealers, but he'll have the voucher. Either way, Gehlen Catholic Ball's coming up on April 20th. That one is being hosted by the LeBon family. They are the general chairs this year. Ryan does great work. He did a great job putting in the sound system here in the gymnasium. He did a great job putting in all the sound and all the work in the cafeteria here at Gehlen. He's done a lot of work here. They are presenting a night in Nashville. It'll be over at the convention center like normal. A lot of great items up for auction, so make sure you stay tuned for more of the information. Find more of it on GehlenCatholic.org. And Catholic Schools Week, Drew, that's coming up. One of your favorite events, Dining with Dads. I'm sure that'll be back again this year.
It's always a fun opportunity to pick on kids while you give away food that they may or may not want.
And that you didn't cook. But
it's better than what I would cook, that's for sure.
That's just part of Catholic Schools Week. There's also a picnic here in the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. There's all kinds of fun activities that happen. And those announcements will be coming out soon. The Jays play next on Tuesday night versus Remsen St. Mary's. That will be on the Remsen St. Mary's Fuller Digital Solutions channel. So make sure you check that out. You can check it out on fullerdigital.net. You can also search YouTube's and you can find it there. As we wind down towards starting lineups here tonight, any final thoughts before starting lineups, Drew?
I'll be curious to see how quickly the Jays jump on HMS. If HMS is going to hang around, and then you never know what could happen, or the Jays not going to take this lightly. And I have not seen HMS play this year. I've seen their junior high play. They've got some good talent coming up. So the record may be misleading.
As we get ready for tonight, remind you that finals are next week. If you have a child in 7 through 12, finals, the odd period finals are on Monday. The even period finals are on Tuesday. And if you finish all of your finals on Monday and Tuesday, no school on Wednesday for 7 through 12. Elementary does come to school on the Wednesday, though. We will turn this one over to our public address announcer.
Good evening once again. Welcome to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym here at Gehlen Catholic for our second game in tonight's boy-girl varsity doubleheader. Let's extend another special welcome to our guest, the Hawks from Hartley, Melvin Sanborn. Gehlen Catholic Schools encourage positive sportsmanship and behavior at the game tonight. By practicing good sportsmanship, you will help make tonight's game one to remember. Let's give a hand for our officials for tonight's game, Royce Raniger, Nick Nelson, and Jason Slaughter. Now let's welcome the coaches. The Hawks are coached by Nathan Hoagland, assisted by Tom Lidiak. The Jays are coached by Ryan Wilchin, assisted by Eric Kellen and Alec Langle. And now here are the starters for the Hawks, a junior number 2, Jaden Leth. For the Jays, a senior number 10, Jackson Kramer. For the Hawks, a senior number 3, George Vargas. For the Jays, a senior number 12, Landon Ryder. For the Hawks, a sophomore number 11, Josh Cruz. For the Jays, a sophomore number 14, Nolan Teal. For the Hawks, a sophomore, number 13, Lawton Shipoff. For the Jays, a senior, number 30, Gabe Wilchin. For the Hawks, a senior, number 23, Bradley Van Beek. For the Jays, a sophomore, number 50, Carson Arnn.
Forget the ramps and hassles when hauling. They are built to tilt. Tilt Bed Trailers, made at Holstein Fabrication and Holstein Manufacturing.
We're excited to now offer one of the best tilt bed trailers on the market, ranging from 22 to 28 feet in length. And like everything we manufacture, these trailers are built to work, last, and make your life easier. Haul with confidence when you hook up to a tilt bed trailer made at Holstein Fabrication and Holstein Manufacturing. Visit us online today at holsteinmfg.com.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford. Tonight's scoreboard brought to you by Ag State, and the bottom line brought to you by Schuster Trucking. Carson Arnn in the center circle as well as Bradley Van Beek, and this one controlled by the Jays. ahead over the timeline is Ryder. Passes left, Kramer back to Ryder. Over to Nolan Teal, down low, Kramer had it now. Top of the key, three, no good. Rebound fought for. Nolan Teal comes away with it, hands it off to Arns. Arns did not reestablish himself when he came back in bounds. Turnover.
HMS comes out the 2-3 zone, and Gehlen settles for a three-point shot immediately. So
drive toward the paint, kicked it back out. Drive again. In the paint, swatted at, and Kramer's going to come away with his first foul. 7:31 in the first. First team, first personal. And we're going to have a 30-second timeout already by the Jays. We'll take it with them. Back in 30 on Fuller.
Since the 1980s, Colbeck Incorporated has been a family-run business providing their customers with quality wood and feed grinding services throughout Northwest Iowa. Colbeck Incorporated knows that your time is valuable, and they pride themselves on getting the job done in a prompt and reliable fashion. Local cattle feeders have been relying on Colbeck Incorporated hay grinding for 30 years, and Brian and Kevin are proud of their partnerships they've built with their customers. Whether it's grinding, mulch, or hauling, call Colbeck Incorporated today and see what they can do for you.
Welcome back to the Tim Dreckman Memorial, or the Deb Campbell Memorial, Jim. My apologies. As Leth drives right side of the paint, puts up a floater off the back iron, no good. Rebound by Arns. Arns quickly ahead to Wilchin. Wilchin over to Kramer. Kramer left wing, back to Wilchin. Wilchin gets it down low, puts it up to Teal, and he is fouled. Teal will go to the line to shoot two. It's on number two, Jaden Leth. That's his first, team's first. Teal puts up the first and knocks it down. Made the joke here with Coach Wilchin a couple games ago when we can expect Nolan Teal to eat some more protein. Knocks up the second and good.
Just an older version of my son, I think.
Couple more peanut butter and jelly sandwiches would do them good. And I think we're going to get a moving screen. We are. That's on Vargas. Kramer, of course, had that knee injury, and that's why he wears the big brace on the left knee there. Kramer in the paint. Wilchin, spinner down. Wilchin with his first 2 points of the game, and Jays lead this one 4-0. That one's stolen away by Kramer, or by Wilchin. Bounce pass ahead to Kramer, and it's stolen away going the other way by Cruz. Cruz brings it up the timeline, kicks it left. Van Beek driving. I think Arns swatted that one away. Ahead, Nolan Teal. Nolan Teal behind the back. Wilchin in the paint, puts it up and in. Cruz drives, left side of the paint, kicks it out. Van Beek, three, good from Josh Cruz. Man, catch and shoot, knock it down, youngster. Kramer, Arns, bounce pass in, spinning. Nolan Teal, three, in and out, no good. Carson Arns, put back, no good. Fought for the rebound, it's going to be off of Arns and out of bounds.
That's not a shot you see him miss very often.
You kind of can't miss those point blankers as Van Beek goes out and Billings comes in. Nice screen, drive, left side of the paint, stolen away. Arns up the court to Wilchin. Wilchin kicks it out. Kramer. Nolan Teal back to Ryder. Kramer tries to get a bouncer in to Wilchin. It's going to stay Jay's basketball.
This zone is moving really quick so far.
Kramer will be the inbounder on the baseline. Gets it in to Ryder. Down low. Kramer puts up the shot. No good. Gets his own rebound and puts it in. Jackson Kramer with two. Jays lead this one by five. Cruz brings it up the floor. Seen the same play about three times coming up the floor from the Hawks. Vargas, shot, no good. Rebound by Nolan Teal. Nolan looking ahead, kicks it right. Back to Nolan Teal, gets it in the paint. Gabe Wilchin, Ryder, bounce pass, Arnes, stripped away, picked up, and Ryder with the foul.
I think we're gonna see a dunk right there. But good hands by HMS to slap that away.
Lawton Shipoff. Got, I guess, brother of the Shipoff from the girls team. He's the inbounder and also the one bringing it up the floor. Stops, feeds, down low underhand from Billings. Nice little finger roll from Billings. It's 8-5. Bounce pass, cross court now. Ryder gets it to Wilchin on the baseline, tries to get it to Teal, stolen away by Vargas. Ahead comes Shipoff, spinning right side of the paint, partially blocked, picked up by Arsons, ahead to Teal. Teal up the floor, stops at the three-point line, gets it to Wilchin in the paint, just in front of the free throw line, knocks down that jumper. He now has 6. Ankle looks nice. Almost a walk there, gets it over to left. Now top of the key, Vargas back to left, pulls the trigger on a long three off the back iron, no good. Picked up by Wilchin, brings it ahead over the timeline with a right hand, stops. Kramer pushing Nolan over to Arnes. Wilchin low, puts up a floater.
Quick ball movement, picks apart the zone.
We're going to get a full timeout from HMS. Back in 60 seconds, you're watching Jays and Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions. And
Senior Lafferty Tuition Foundation awards tuition scholarships to students that attend a Catholic school in the Diocese of Sioux City. By contributing to MLTF, donors are eligible to receive a 75% tax credit from the state of Iowa. There is no other charitable gift that offers you a credit like that. It is also the perfect time of year to consider a gift of grain to MLTF. You can find more information about MLTF at scdiocese.org under the Giving tab. Please consider a gift to MLTF to give the gift of Catholic education.
Since the 1980s, Colbeck Incorporated has been a family-run business providing their customers with quality wood and feed grinding services throughout Northwest Iowa. Colbeck Incorporated knows that your time is valuable, and they pride themselves on getting the job done in a prompt and reliable fashion. Local cattle feeders have been relying on Colbeck Incorporated hay grinding for 30 years, and Brian and Kevin are proud of their partnerships they've built with their customers. Whether it's grinding, mulch, or hauling, call Colbeck Incorporated today and see what they can do for you.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling, Drew Bickford. Tonight's scoreboard brought to you by Ag State. Scoreboard in the lower left-hand corner, shot clock lower right. Bottom line brought to you by Schuster Trucking. Vargas kicks it over to left, far corner. HMS showing a little bit smaller. That jumper no good. 34 Langle in the ballgame. Gets it out to Trevor Teal. Trevor kicks it over to the Ryder. Ryder bounce pass to 24 Langle. Langle drove that far baseline. That one's going to be tipped out of bounds off of Vargas.
He drove baseline, looked for that cutter down the middle, but no cutter to be found.
So now 34 Langle with the inbound. Gets it in to Ryder. Ryder to Lehman. Back out to 34 Langle. Ryder, top of the key. Trevor Teal over to 24 Langle. Back out to Teal. Ryder with 5 on the shot clock. Teal, 3, no good. And it's going to be out of bounds. Both out of bounds and a shot clock violation. 2:37 left to go here in the first quarter.
Just rushed that shot a little bit. Had to get it up with the shot clock running low.
Cruz brought it up over the timeline, drives in the paint, center, floater, no good, rebound by 34 Langle. Ryder brings it up the floor, kicks it to Lehman. Lehman walked with the basketball. He was looking for options and walked.
Shuffled the feet, got a little excited.
A little more girth in, bring Wilchin back in and sitting Ryder. Cruz brings it up over the timeline with a right hand. Now with the left, around the arc. Ball being swung nicely. Kick back. Three. Good. Cruz that knocked that one down. He now has six. Gets it to Wilchin in the paint. Spins. Puts it up off the back iron. No good. Rebound. Wilchin thought about a three. Head fake. Kicks it out to Teal. Thought he would have taken a shot there. Gets it to Lehman. Down in the paint. It's going to be off of his big thundering legs and out of bounds.
Tough pass to catch. Not a bad idea. Just couldn't quite handle it.
Hello to his mom, Mel, watching in South Dakota tonight. Appreciate you tuning in to Four Digital Solutions as Billings picked up that foul off the ball.
Billings, a big, big solid kid. That's a few times now that he just hasn't quite come set. That's the first one they've called, but got to be a pretty good screener. Love to come off those type of screens.
A little bit of a road grader. Langle left. Wilchin in the corner. Kicks it out to Teal. Top of the key. Trevor, that is. Trevor down low. Wilchin puts it up off the glass and in. Gabe Wilchin with 11. Welcome back, big fella. Cruz dribbles. Handoff. Three. No good. Rebound by Arnes. Trevor Teal bringing it up the floor. Stay tuned at halftime. Wilchin puts it up off the glass as the dance team will perform here tonight. We'll also have Coach Shecker on. 16-8. We're going to have the official's going to get one of the yellow bouncy balls that rolled away from the students on the sideline. Three-point attempt, no good. Rebound by Kramer. Normally I would have blown that one dead.
I'm surprised he didn't.
Athletic official. That one, Kramer got elevation. Corner three, Wilchin thought about it. Long two, no good. Just kissed the front of the rim. He's got more muscle on than that normally.
He doesn't miss a lot of weight room sessions.
No, he doesn't. Ship off, handed off. That one picked up by Kramer with 15 on the clock. Trevor Teal puts up a reverse layup and good. Trevor Teal with the first two the hard way.
A lot of spin on that one.
Cruz drives, paint, floater, swatted at by Carson Arnes. 1 second, Teal, I don't think he got that one off in time. Didn't fall anyway. 18-8 is how this one ends in the first quarter. Back in 60 on Fuller.
AgriVision Equipment and Exact Emerge Planter Technology is here to help you maximize your yield and efficiency, along with a proven 8 bushel per acre yield advantage because of the pinpoint accuracy of seed depth and placement. You can cover 50 acres per hour without compromising your stand. We know the risk of planting outside the optimal planting window, so don't let the weather control your bottom line. When you partner with AgriVision Equipment, you get access to the best service and technology support in the area. And visit any one of our 15 locations today to learn more about our large selection of new and used planters. AgriVision Equipment, focused on your future.
Reliance means being dependable. And when it comes to comfort in your home, you want Reliance from a place you can trust with a product you can count on. That's why Marcus Lumber stocks Reliance brand water heaters. Because with Reliance in the name, it's the brand you can trust. Marcus Lumber has been stocking and installing Reliance water heaters for decades. So choose the name you trust for your home. Choose Marcus Lumber and Reliance water heaters.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford tonight. And the Jays kind of dominated this first quarter. They were really slow to start. And it looks like I'm looking over toward the Jays bench and Landon Ryder is, I think, going to get an ankle taped up here.
Jays doing a good job of quick ball movement, moving that zone and then getting another pass before the zone has a chance to get set.
We're going to have another off the ball moving screen, I think, and it's going to be on Van Beek. Sorry about that interruption, Drew.
No, you're good. Gabe Wilchin has been actually the receiving end for most of the quick passes. A quick 12 points.
Bounce pass, backdoor cutter, two-hand flush. Carson Arnes, first time showing that off in the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Pearson with it, tries to get it down low. That one intercepted by 34 Lengel. Wilchin ahead, bounce pass, a little bit behind Kramer, over to Arnes, tries to get it to Wilchin, almost went in off of a tip. Wouldn't know who to credit that to. Cruz quickly up the floor, kicks it back out, ship off, deep, three, no good, fought for. Wilchin comes away with it, gets it ahead quickly to Trevor Teal. Trevor Teal brings it up over the timeline, down low, 34, Lengel, good. Jays lead this one 22-8. And Cruz bounce pass over to Pearson. Pearson backs up, now drives, baseline, right hand, steps out of bounds. It's going to be a turnover.
You see Carson Arnes walking around. He just doesn't strike you as a guy that's athletic. But then he jumps out of the gym and gets up and down the court faster than anybody else. It's a pretty quiet kid. It's just, he just goes about his business.
Lengel back out to Kramer, back to 34 Lengel, back to Kramer. 20 seconds on the shot clock, spinning. Arnes puts it off the back iron. No good, rebound by Van Beek. Ahead to Cruz. Bounce pass, Van Beek pulls the trigger on a deep three, no good. It's gonna be off of 34 Lengel and out of bounds. Ryder's going to come back into the ball game. I wonder if he got a scratch instead of an ankle tape there. 6:24 left to go in the second. Jays lead this one 22-8. Hawks will be the inbounders. Get it in. Thought they were going to pull trigger on a quick three, and Kramer commits that foul. That's going to be his second, team's first of the second quarter. Cruz, the inbounder, slaps the ball, says, let's get moving, boys. Gets the dribble handoff, gets a nice screen also. Three, corner, no good. Rebound by Nolan Teal. Nolan to Kramer. Kramer beyond the arc to Trevor Teal. Trevor to Nolan. Tried to feed Carson Arnes. I think Carson wanted another two-handed flush, as Cruz brings it up the floor for the Hawks. Cruz with a right hand, top of the key, bounce pass, swatted at, and travel with the basketball as he was sliding along the floor.
That's a tough call. He died for that one and kind of bobbled it. I didn't think he even had possession yet. Understand the call, but.
Ryder kicks left, Trevor Teal. Are they playing a... They're playing a 3-2 zone there as it goes off of Nolan Teal and into the waiting arms of Shipoff. Cruz brought it up over the timeline, stops at the top of the key, kicks it right to left. Tries to feed it down low. Instead, got a cutter on the baseline. Vargas, three-point corner, no good. Rebound by Teal. Trevor Teal brings it up the court and... they didn't reset the shot clock. There's 10, I looked up on the clock. I was trying to figure out what they were calling. The shot clock never got reset. The officials are going to put 30 on the shot clock with how quick the Jays brought the ball up over the timeline. So they're working on getting that. Sean does a great job at the scorer's table working that clock, getting it reset. Sean Vasura. Kramer. Over to 34, Lengel, back to Kramer, top of the key, wanted to get it back to Lengel instead, gets it to Ryder, back to Kramer. Kramer gets it to Nolan Teal, 3-point, 34, Lengel knocks it down. Aiden Lengel, number 34, he now has 5 of the Jays' 25. That one just off the tips of Leth, he's able to get his own as Van Beek is at the top of the key. Cruz with it. Cruz left to Van Beek. 17 on the shot clock. Back to Cruz. Tries to get it to left. Stolen away by Kramer. Kramer puts up a right hand and in. Jaxton Kramer with 4. 27-8 the score. Cruz, and we're going to have another offensive foul. Foul is going to be on George Vargas. It's going to be his second. It's going to be the team's second, and we are going to have a timeout. Didn't quite catch the length on it. It's a Foley. Take it with them back in 60 on Fuller Digital Solutions.
Whether you are combining, hauling grain, or heating your home, fuel powers the fall. When it comes to energy, you need a company who is trustworthy, understands your needs, and who delivers to you. A company who is local, reliable, and affordable. That company is Ag State. Ag State Energy is clean, comfortable, convenient, while staying competitively priced for our customers. Give Laura Sanguin or Seth Duff a call for all your energy needs.
MHI and Cuso of Cherokee are on the move, expanding, and in need of residential treatment workers, psychiatric security specialists, and LPNs.
We deal with disorders that you can't see. You get to help people who are in desperate need of help. And helping those people actually helps the community as well.
The benefits here, I think, are top-notch. That was why I came here.
To learn more and to apply, visit governmentjobs.com.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling, Drew Bickford. Kramer brings it up over the line. Landon Ryder. Sideline, pokes
great
it up.
Backdoor cut.
Teal now with four. Cruz, top of the key, passes right to Shipoff, backdoor cut. Kramer comes away with the basketball. Kramer brings it up over the timeline, into the near corner. Ryder. Jays have gone a little bit away from what their bread and butter early on was with Wilchin. Wilchin has it now, double teamed almost. Nolan Teal up the right side of the paint. It's poked away. It's going to be off of Nolan Teal out of bounds.
That was a weird possession for HMS because they went back to man-to-man, and as the shot clock went down, they got out of position or they went back to a 2-3.
Cruz hands it off to Shipoff, over to Van Beek. Van Beek to Cruz to Van Beek. Deep three, no good. It's going to be, wow. I thought it was off of Langle. Instead, they say it was off of Vargas. Either way, Jays with the basketball. Kramer brings it up over the timeline. Kicks it left to Ryder, Nolan Teal. Nolan at the free throw line, gets it down. Wilchin, fadeaway jumper, in and out, no good. Nolan Teal with a putback. He now has six. It's 31-8. Vargas brings it up over the timeline. Right hand, handoff to Shipoff. And we're going to have a hockey line coming in. Substitution at the whistle. 2:44 left to go in the second. We're going to have a 5-for-5, and two Hawks are going to come off the bench.
That's one thing about this Jays team. A lot of depth, a lot of shooters everywhere. I mean, really not a lot of fall off. Being you don't have any star players, there's not a lot of fall off, and that's a positive to have this year.
Trevor to Dane, tries to get it down low, picked up by Billings. Vargas will bring it up over the Cruz brings it up over the timeline. Cruz with it, top of the key. Three, off the backboard and iron, no good. Lame comes away with a rebound. Lehman. Bounce pass into Arnes, kicks it out to Trevor Teal. Trevor, long three, and he knocks it down. Trevor with five now, and it's 34-8. Jay's on an impossible run right now. 20-0 as Lehman pokes that one away. Trevor Teal quickly up the floor, feet tied up, and Trevor did a nice job of avoiding falling on the flying Hawk. Cruz brought it up the floor. It's going to be off the fingertips of Pearson, out of bounds. And we are going to get Dalma into the ball game. He is just a freshman. And a 30-second timeout. HMS might burn through all their timeouts here in the first half. Back in 30 on Fuller.
Whether you are combining, hauling grain, or heating your home, fuel powers the fall. When it comes to energy, you need a company who is trustworthy, understands your needs, and who delivers to you. A company who is local,
reliable, and affordable. That company is Ag State. Ag State Energy is clean, comfortable, convenient, while staying competitively priced for our customers. Give Laura Sanguin or Seth Duff a call for all your energy needs.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford. And that's going to be off of the foot of Leth and out of bounds.
HMS saw that pass to the middle, and then we're looking to pass right back to the baseline for the lay-in. Now that pass is there for the middle, but now it's just a little floater right there. Just got to shoot it.
Trevor Teal knocks down another three. He has 10. 37-8. Dalma, it's going to be off the hands. It was a touch, so no over and back. Back to Dalma. Top of the key, ship off, spinning in the lane, puts it up and in. Lawton ship off, able to break that one. It's 39-10. Lehman, down low, Arnes puts up that bunny. Arnes with a simple four. Puts up a jumper, no good, rebound by Arnes. Lubin will bring it up for the Jays. Dylan Lubin down low, Carson Arnes. That one tipped. Lehman comes away with it, back to Arnes. Arnes jump stops, puts up a shot, and he is fouled. I believe he was fouled by Alex Billings.
You don't see him give any facial expressions, or his body language never changes. Kind of a boring player. As a coach, kind of like that. But he kind of looked at the ref after the first time. Got hammered once. He didn't blow the whistle. Then he wanted the ball back, and then he went aggressive.
Arnes now with five. Well, it says three on the board. Where am I missing points at? Arnes hits the second. And the Hawks will bring the ball up over the timeline. Leth with it now. Leth gets it to Dalma. Pearson drives, and 24 Langle commits the foul. He has one. Team has two. Oh, they're going to call it on Lubin. I'm sorry. Dalma inbounds the basketball. Shot fake and turnover.
Early in the second half, I think we'll see some players we haven't seen much this season. So that's fun for those players that don't get to see a lot of varsity minutes. Not as fun for the players that play a lot of minutes because they want their playing time too.
Stay tuned for the dance team here at halftime. Kickball, and then we'll have Coach Schecker. Jays with a 33-point lead here. Remember, 35 gets you a running clock. Inbound to Lubin. Lubin to Teal. And Lehman able to knock it down right before the buzzer. Jays lead this one by a score of 45-10. As we get ready for the dance team here at halftime, it looks like they're going to put on some kind of, looks like holiday performance, I believe. I will clear off my overlays here for you so you get a better look. The only thing I need for sure is here, and I'll get rid of your shot clock for you. Remove that. And we will turn this over to our public address system.
Okay, tonight we have our Christmas dance. This is choreographed by Brooklyn, Paisley, Libby, Gracie, and Marin.
My winter nights are taken up by static stress and holiday shopping traffic. But I close my eyes
and I'm somewhere else, just like magic. My heart is a Christmas tree farm where the people would come to dance under sparkles and lights, bundled up in their mittens and coats, and the cider would flow. And I just wanna be there tonight. Sweet dreams of holly and ribbon, mistakes are forgiven, and everything is icy and blue. And you would be there too, under the mistletoe, watching the fire glow.
Senior Lafferty Tuition Foundation awards tuition scholarships to students that attend a Catholic school in the Diocese of Sioux City. By contributing to MLTF, donors are eligible to receive a 75% tax credit from the state of Iowa. There is no other charitable gift that offers you a credit like that. It is also the perfect time of year to consider a gift of grain to MLTF. You can find more information about MLTF at scdiocese.org under the Giving tab. Please consider a gift to MLTF to give the gift of Catholic education.
Since the 1980s, Colbeck Incorporated has been a family-run business providing their customers with quality wood and feed grinding services throughout Northwest Iowa. Colbeck Incorporated knows that your time is valuable, and they pride themselves on getting the job done in a prompt and reliable fashion. Local cattle feeders have been relying on Colbeck Incorporated hay grinding for 30 years, and Brian and Kevin are proud of their partnerships they've built with their customers. Whether it's grinding, mulch, or hauling, call Colbeck Incorporated today and see what they can do for you.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling now joined by Coach Brandon Schecker. And Coach, it was a little bit of a difficult night, and some of the length of HMS really made it that much more difficult.
Oh, were they tall?
They had a little bit of reach on them.
Unbelievable. I want 3 6-foot plus girls on my team one year to see what we can do. Yeah, that was a little struggle, especially to start out. We weren't ready for their height. I don't know how you get ready for their height. In fact, my halftime speech was, ladies, this is what I need. I need three of you to grow 6 inches before the half is over. You know, I kudos to them. They utilize their height well. But, you know, I thought the second half, though, I thought we adjusted. Even in the second quarter, I thought we adjusted a little bit, went a little bit different defense, made some different moves, and I thought our defense held up okay. It just, again, it wasn't enough to counteract 3 6-foot plus girls out there, especially with my two top tallest girls injured and on the bench.
So. Yeah, I was going to make that comment also, but you guys were still able to find a way to get Rizea 16 points here tonight.
Yeah, Rizea is going to do her thing. She continues to lead us night in and night out, and the nice thing is even when she wasn't knocking down buckets, she was making things happen on the offensive end. And you know, when we missed, there was opportunities for the other girls to get a nice rebound and put back. So kudos to the whole team tonight. I thought all 10, you know, I went 10 deep, and I thought all 10 played well and mixed things up tonight to try something, you know, a little bit different. Was super happy. Hate losing, hate the loss, but absolutely love the effort and attitude by all 10 tonight. It was great contribution by all of them.
Point out two more that I just want to spotlight is Grace Kellen. I felt like every time I looked up, she was poking the ball out of bounds or she was hustling after the ball. And for what this has been, what the season's been, you got to be impressed with that kind of hustle.
Absolutely. And what was the greatest thing about it is I started her tonight, gave her a chance. We're mixing things up a little bit, so forth along that lines, getting a bunch of girls some more playing time. I started Grace tonight, and I thought instead of that sophomore, you know, having to come out and be a little held back, reserved, I thought she kind of let it loose. And that's exactly what we've been asking of the girls, is to stop playing so tight, play loose, enjoy the moment. And I thought Grace took advantage of that starting spot tonight and did very well.
I know it's still really early on, But Bella Schrader, you just brought her up this year, and she's still very raw, but she looked very impressive tonight. She her presence in the lane, I felt like, wreaked a lot of havoc for HMS.
She's my six-footer, and she did. She's been working hard, and you know, it's something that we've been working with her on. Gave her the varsity uniform just this week. Looking for more minutes out of her. I thought she did really well in the JV game tonight. Is really taking some of the things that Coach Kolbeck and myself are helping out with. And she's listening, and she's putting them to good use in practice. And I thought she did a really good job in both the JV game as well as the varsity minutes that she got tonight. I thought she played well. If she continues that, she will be that six-foot presence for us moving forward, which would be wonderful.
And can you imagine having her and Sammy and Hallie healthy next year?
And Bay. Oh, yeah, losing Bay, but having all three of them to be able to be healthy and be able to give us some of that size, that'd be wonderful.
That being said, you guys have a bit of a daunting challenge ahead of you on Tuesday night before you guys take a little bit of a Christmas break.
Absolutely. Remsen St. Mary's, it will be a tough game, but, you know, that's what you do. I mean, you go play the game. You just never know. We'll have a nice little shoot-around practice tomorrow morning, get some weightlifting in. And then the JVC squad have a game over in Hinton on Monday, so actually not going to get a full, true practice with the girls before Tuesday night. But as I told them tonight, if we play with the effort and attitude that we did on defense tonight, too bad we didn't get some threes to fall with that tall length tonight. If we would have got some threes to fall, that's a completely different game. So if we can play defense like we did tonight on Tuesday night and knock down a few shots, maybe we can give Remsen a game, and that'd be fun.
Coach, appreciate you joining us. Good luck on Tuesday night, and Merry Christmas. We'll see you after the break.
Sounds good. Thanks, Matt. Appreciate it as always.
That was Coach Schecker. We'll be back in 60 seconds. You're watching.
AgriVision Equipment and ExactEmerge Planter Technology is here to help you maximize your yield and efficiency, along with a proven 8 bushel per acre yield advantage because of the pinpoint accuracy of seed depth and placement. You can cover 50 acres per hour without compromising your stand. We know the risk of planting outside the optimal planting window, so don't let the weather control your bottom line. When you partner with AgriVision Equipment, you get access to the best service and technology support in the area. And visit any one of our 15 locations today to learn more about our large selection of new and used planters. AgriVision Equipment, focused on your future.
Reliance means being dependable. And when it comes to comfort in your home, you want Reliance from a place you can trust with a product you can count on. That's why Marcus Lumber stocks Reliance brand water heaters. Because with Reliance in the name, it's the brand you can trust. Marcus Lumber has been stocking and installing Reliance water heaters for decades. So choose the name you trust for your home. Choose Marcus Lumber and Reliance water heaters.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling joined by Drew Bickford here tonight. The first half scoring looked like this. Cruz had 6, Shipoff had 2, and Billings had 2. For the Jays, Trevor Teal had 10, Jackson Kramer had 4, Nolan Teal had 6, Gabe Wilchin with 13, 34, Aiden Langle with 5, and Carson Arns had that monster dunk and 6. Sorry, 5 points. Dane Lehman also had 2. Jays really exploded there in the second quarter, Drew.
Yeah, came out a little bit slow. A timeout 29 seconds into the game, and the team responded. So really good to see them respond to the timeout, respond to Coach Wilchin, and really attack that zone really well. The 2-3 hasn't really given Gehlen much problems this year. The zone that we've had a tough time picking apart is the 1-3-1. I can tell you, I bet they're putting a lot of time in practice making sure that when the 1-3-1 comes next time, they're ready for it.
Appreciate Ag State Bank for bringing you tonight's scoreboard in the lower left-hand corner, shot clock in the lower right corner. And tonight's bottom line brought to you by Schuster Trucking. As we get ready to start this second half, the Jays will start with the basketball. It's a 35-point clock, and Drew, do you remember what the point differential is? Do they need to bring back down within 25 when the clock goes back, or is it just 35?
I am not sure. I don't know that
I can't remember off the top of my head. It's been a while since the Jays have done that. Ball's kicked over. Ryder to Wilchin. Wilchin kicks it out to Kramer. Kramer drives left side of the paint. No good. Rebound by Leth. Leth hands it off to Cruz, who brings it up over the timeline for the Hawks. Hawks, top of the key, kicks left, bounce low. Puts up a shot, no good. Rebound by Vargas. I thought I heard a whistle for a second. It must have been a squeaking shoe.
Right at the right time.
Wilchin puts down a floater. Fadeaway, he now has 15. 47-10 is the score. Kick left to ship off, back right to Leth. Leth puts up the three, no good off the back iron. Nolan Teal comes up with a rebound, almost walked with the basketball, as that one's poked away and come up with by Van Beek. Cruz brings it over the timeline. Van Beek, far side, stops, kicks it out, poked away by Kramer. Kramer puts up a layup and in. Jackson Kramer with six. 48-10. Sorry, 49-10. I can't do math. Kicked out. Almost poked away by Ryder just by sticking his arm out. Cruz with it now. Cruz pushes to left. Left corner. Van Beek. Far corner. Wants to get a little help. Now cross-court pass to Cruz. Cruz near the top of the key. Stops. Kicks out. Van Beek. Three. No good. Rebound by by Nolan Teal. Nolan will bring it up over the timeline. Pushes right to Gabe Wilchin. Back to Nolan Teal. Back to Gabe Wilchin. Gabe gets it down to Carson Arns. Back out to Gabe. Cutter. Floating. No good. Rebound. Van Beek. 2 minutes eclipsed here in this second or third quarter, rather. Cruz with it now near the top of the key. With a right hand. Pushes to left. Left over to Van Beek. Van Beek, top of the key, pushes right to ship off. He loses control of that one. Nolan Teal drives, puts up a shot, and is fouled from behind by Jaden Leth, who picks up his third.
Dangerous foul, chasing from behind, a little shove. Luckily, everybody's okay.
He didn't go down hard, and so that's why there was nothing extra on that foul.
Sometimes those are the awkward ones that kind of come down funny.
Teal puts up the first. Good. He now has seven. Jays eclipse 50. As we see at least one new body in the game with Hanks. And quickly ahead, three knocked down by Leth. Jaden Leth breaks a long scoreless drought. Kramer near the top of the key, shot fake Teal. Kramer, corner, bounce pass into Caden Hanks. He falls down. And we have a defensive foul on the Jays. I didn't see anything called, so I'm not quite sure what
it
was.
Out of bounds?
Maybe.
Not sure what happened there.
Cruz, now left. Left, kicks left, top of the key. Pearson, Pearson spins in the paint, kicks it out left, three. No good, rebound. As putback is no good by Vargas, but he is fouled by Landon Ryder. That's going to be Ryder's team's first of the second half, well, third quarter. Quarter fouls, not half fouls.
HMS settled for a lot of threes in the first half. You've really seen, they must have talked about doing the ball inside, trying to work the ball inside. They don't have a lot of size, but that doesn't necessarily mean you want to settle for three-point shots. So HMS, give them credit, they're still trying to do some work down low.
Landon Knipe now in the basketball game. Well, lane violation, but it is canceled out by Vargas's first point of the ball game. 51-14. Knipe tries to, I think he saw in the periphery Nolan Teal, threw it away to Vargas. Vargas, head fake, kicks it out. Pearson. Pearson dribbles toward the baseline, puts up a jumper, partially blocked. Landon Knipe comes away with it. Knipe brings it up the floor, pushes left, Ryder. Ryder back to Knipe, back to Ryder. I like Knipe's size. Over to Nolan Teal. Ryder, three-point attempt is true. And Ryder's on the board. Not used to taking Landon Ryder this long to get on the board. Dalmo Vargas.
Way to seal. George Vargas did a really good job sealing off his defender. Some more shot clock issues.
Got it. I missed what the call was. That's my fault. Kind of looking around. Clock stays running because of the point differential. You'll see that on the Ag State scoreboard. Knipe gets it in. Zach Carpenaugh. 34 Langle over to Trevor Teal. Trevor near the top of the key gets it out to Hanks. 34 Langle to Carpenaugh. Nice cut and get by Teal. 56 to 17 as Leth gets that corner three.
It's his second three of the second half.
Jay's kind of caught napping there.
Didn't match up.
Hello to Jill Harpenaugh, resting up at home. Hope you're doing well. Appreciate you tuning in. Also the Christoffel family up in the Granville area. That shot's no good. Rebound by Vargas. Quickly ahead, will Leth take another three? Nope, drives toward the baseline and he is fouled by Trevor Teal. That's gonna be Teal's first. It's the team's second of the third quarter. So it'll be a baseline inbound. Inbound by Dalma. He's only a freshman. He's got room to grow. That one's out of bounds off the hands of Cruz. He doesn't quite have the height of what his sister has.
No, not a lot of height overall on this team. All pretty similar in size.
Trevor Teal cutting Dane Lehman. Count the basket. And the foul for Lehman. He now has four. 58-17. 30-second timeout for HMS. We'll take it with them back in 30 on Fuller.
Since the 1980s, Colbeck Incorporated has been a family-run business providing their customers with quality wood and feed grinding services throughout Northwest Iowa. Colbeck Incorporated knows that your time is valuable, and they pride themselves on getting the job done in a prompt and reliable fashion. Local cattle feeders have been relying on Colbeck Incorporated hay grinding for 30 years, and Brian and Kevin are proud of their partnerships they've built with their customers. Whether it's grinding, mulch, or hauling, call Colbeck Incorporated today and see what they can do for you.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling joined by Drew Bickford. And Drew, appreciate you joining us here tonight as Dane Lehman is at the line to try to complete the traditional three-point play.
Yeah, Coach Wilson's going to use the rest of this time now to get some players in that maybe haven't played as much or that are just playing a few minutes here and there and getting them more comfortable being on the court. That's the second time we've seen nobody pick up Jaden Leth. That's his third three of the second half. He's not missing.
That'll be something that I think Coach Wilson will be able to talk about. 34, yep. Langle puts up a three of his own. No good. Rebound by the Bull in the China Shop. Dane Lehman. Trevor Teal knocks that one down.
Yeah, regardless of the score, you don't want to build any bad habits. You don't want to play lazy basketball. No matter who's in, you want to be crisp.
Josh, let's go ahead.
So, yeah, that Coach Wilson's going to be seeing that nobody picks up Jaden Leth two times in a row. That's an issue.
And three times this quarter because he scored all three of those threes in this half. Time continuing to wind down because of the point differential. 35 point equals a running clock both in football and in basketball here in the state of Iowa. 3-point attempt off in and out. No good. Rebound by Zach Harpinoff. Zach will bring it up, kick it over to Aiden Langle. 34 Langle. Bounce pass into Lehman. Lehman spins, puts up a floater, no good. Rims out left. Somebody found him, drives baseline, puts it up, and he is going to be fouled by 34, Aiden Langle. Leth will go to the line to shoot two. Shot clock turned off. First free throw attempt off the back iron, no good. Second free throw attempt by Leth is up. No good. Rebound by Lehman. Lehman brings it up over the timeline. Pushes Zach Harpinoff. No good. Rebound fought for. Lehman comes up with it. Gives it to Harpinoff. Fought for again. Poked away from Lehman. And Cruz brings it up as time expires. 62-22 at the end of three. We'll be back with the final quarter after this. You're watching Jays and Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions.
Staying healthy means enjoying life's best moments. And the best way to stay healthy is to make your routine appointments. Whether you have new symptoms or it's time for your annual exam, the providers at Floyd Valley Healthcare know and listen to you, so you'll get the care that you need. We help you stay healthy by providing preventative care, finding health concerns early, managing chronic conditions, and connecting you with specialty care close to home. Don't miss a single special moment. Make your appointment today.
When it's time to choose a bank, the choice is easy. Prime Bank is the bank for you.
With all the conveniences you want in a bank, including a mobile app and online account opening, Prime Bank also offers you-pick checking with no monthly fees or minimum balances. And the best part is, you get paid for everyday banking transactions. That's right. Prime Bank's you-pick checking. We pay you for your everyday checking account transactions.
Choose Prime Bank. It's the bank for you. Earn more your way with Prime Bank.
Member FDIC.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford and some more names that we will be learning about the Jays here tonight as we see Owen Seavers in the basketball game. Ball inbounded to Billings. Hand it back off to Cruz. Corner. Three. No good. Rebounded by Hanks. Hanks ahead to Seavers. Seavers with a left hand. Steps back. Now back toward the baseline. Kicks it back out to Lubin. Harpinoff with it now. Top of the key. Kicks left. Owen Seavers. Seavers kicks right to 24 Langle. Back to Harpinoff. Hey, Langle, how you doing? That one swapped away. Picked up by Shipoff. Ahead. Jays, nice job getting back in transition defense. Three, good. That one by Kobe Dama. His first three of the game, and it's 62-25.
They've taken less three-pointers this half and made way more than the first half.
Harpinoff with it now in the lane. Puts up a left hand, no good. And that one's going to be on Billings, his third. I think Billings thought that Harpinoff possibly pushed off on that one. Harpinoff puts up the first. Front rim, back rim, knocks down his first varsity point. Makes it 63-25. Harpinoff trying to make it 2-for-2 from the line. Puts up the second. In and out, no good. Rebound by Hanks. Out of his hands, it's going to be Jay's basketball. Or it's going to be, sorry, Hawks basketball. I think everybody on the list has played for the Jays. Left, kicks it out to Dalma. Cruz with it now, between the legs dribble at the baseline, puts it up, no good. Rebound by Lubin. Lubin pushes ahead to Seavers. Seavers puts it up, no good. Rebound by Billings. Quickly ahead, swiped away. it's going to be out of bounds as Lubin runs up to the third row of the bleachers. A little bit of an impressive feat of athleticism.
He lacks size, but he is quick. Speaking of size, this coming Tuesday against Remsen St. Mary's, Colin Holman's always kind of been a problem for Gehlen with his size. It'll be real interesting to see how Carson Arns matches up. Finally, Gehlen kind of has a big that can kind of match that a little bit. That'll be an interesting test.
He just doesn't have the girth that Holman does.
And he hasn't been pushed around too much this year, but he hasn't met somebody as muscular as Collins. So that'll be an interesting test.
So if you're in Wilchin's position as three rattles in and out, no good, are you going to put Arns with a little less size? You know, height-wise you got it, but weight-wise you don't, put up an in by Leth. Or are you going to put up, or are you going to put Gabe Wilchin in the spot because there is a little more girth there?
That's an option. I bet you'll see both of them on him at some point. I think Callen's averaging about 18 a game this year, so he's putting the ball in the bucket.
Three-point attempt by Severs, no good. Ball fought for and brought ahead by Cruz. Cruz kicks right into the corner left. Left out to the top of the key is ship off. Kicks it left. Cruz left. Drives in the paint. Puts up a floater. No good. Rebound by Hanks. Hanks gets it to Lubin. He'll bring it up the floor. 4:44 left to go in the fourth. Tonight's scoreboard brought to you by Ag State. Shot clock in the right corner. Tonight's bottom line brought to you by Schuster Trucking. Lubin had a cutting Owen. Severs back to Lubin. Top of the key. Knipe. Hanks in the paint. Back out to Knipe. Knipe drives, puts up a floater, no good, rebound by Cruz. Cruz will bring it up the floor for HMS. Kicks right, now directing traffic. Left with it, hands it off to Cruz. Cruz gets it to the near side, driving, ship off, no good, rebound by Hanks. Ahead to Severs. Severs with 4 minutes halfway through this fourth. Driving Knipe. I thought I saw his jersey get pulled from the back. No call as that shot misses.
Cruz left hand just missed it.
I have never been over to Remsen for a basketball game. And I'm not going to go Tuesday night either. I'll watch it on Fuller. As Shipoff knocks down that three.
Usually a pretty fun atmosphere.
I was just going to say, it's a very full, ends up being a very full gym. I just can't imagine trying to get a broadcast out of there. They do a good job over there. Dean Christoffel and his partner over there do a nice job of the broadcast. We'll have Dean on here when St. Mary's comes here on January 9th. We'll be back on the air here on January 2nd as the Jays, I believe, take on Akron Westfield that night. Tip time will be 6 o'clock with the girls. Boys game to follow. As Leth, as he drove that one, was fouled by Zach Harpinaw, who picks up his first, team's first, of the fourth quarter. Clock stops with the foul. Is he talking to Hanks? I think he is talking to Hanks. I thought for a second that Billings was talking to a cheerleader. First shot rattles around and out. No good. Second free throw attempt from left is up, and he knocks that one down. Left now has 12 on the night. Lubin brings it up the floor, passes left to Knipe. Harpinaw over to Lubin. Lubin backdoor, Hanks.
I think
Hanks wanted to try to put down a two-hand slammer, but pulled back at the last second. 65-31. Cruz now left. Pulls up three, got a little contact on the wrist. No call as Hanks comes away with it. Harpinaw ahead. Shot put up, knocked down for Landon Knight. His first 2 points of the ball game at 67-31. Left on the near side, top of the three, top of the key three from Shipoff is good. He now has 8. 67-34 is Lubin. Thought he was going to hand it off to Severs. Now he passes it left to Severs. Now to Harpinaw. Back to Lubin on the far side. 90 seconds left in this ball game. Backdoor. Hanks puts that one up and in. Caden Hanks now with 4.
Owen Severs and Dylan Lubin are the only two that haven't scored on the sheet so far. Dylan has had a few really good assists, though.
I think Cruz had his foot stepped on as he tried to put that one up. And they're going to call the foul on Zach Harpinaw. It's going to be his second, team second of the quarter, and we will see the remaining 3 Hawks that have not played in the ball game yet come in as Cruz puts up the first off the back iron, the strap. I don't think that one could count even if it fell because it hit that safety strap.
Josh Cruz hit 2 early threes, I think both in the first quarter. Hasn't scored since.
Jays had that huge run end of the third quarter, or end of the second quarter, or all of the second quarter and into the third quarter as Cruz misses the second. Hanks comes away with that one. Ahead comes Knipe. Knipe. And they're going to stop for the sub. Now HMS will have played all 10 of their players. The score is 69-34. Knipe back to Severs, over to Harpinaw. Harpinaw, Owens, Knipe, 3, knocks it down.
Banked it in.
Bank's still open here in Lamar's. Mendering got it to Kunzman. I think they're trying to get that one to Dolphin, possibly for an alley-oop. About a 2.5 second difference, shot clock to game clock, as Lubin brought it up the floor. Lubin, cross court, Harpinaw tipped it as Severs back to Knipe. Bounce pass to Lubin. Lubin tries to get it down low. Hanks puts that one up and in. Caden Hanks with 6, and nice pass. These young kids feeding the senior.
All 3 assists from Dylan Lubin.
5 left on the clock. 3 at the buzzer, Dalma. And that one ends this game, 74-34. We'll tally up the stats, get them back to you here on the other side of this break. You're watching Jays and Hawks on Fuller Digital Solutions.
Catholic in Lamar's, Iowa instills respect and Christian values in a caring environment for students preschool through 12th grade. Teachers and staff go above and beyond to provide a high quality education and are dedicated to student success. We are a community striving to live God's word each day through academics, service opportunities, athletics, and so much more. Gehlen Catholic School, in partnership with Spalding Catholic School, all are welcome to experience excellence in education and leadership through Christ.
Sitzman Construction, Lamar's, general contractors you can trust with the job you need done, when you need it done. Call Jeremy at Sitzman Construction when you need a remodel or a complete build, and they work with EPS buildings. Jeremy takes the time to know what you need. Past clients say he's reliable, honest, fair-minded, and reasonably priced. Contact Jeremy at Sitzman Construction. Jeremy and his crew will satisfy all of your construction needs. 712-540-2731.
Welcome back to the Deb Campbell Memorial Gym. Matt Schilling alongside Drew Bickford, and it's a final 74-34 in favor of the Jays here tonight.
A lot of scoring early for the Jays. Switched up some bodies. Scoring slowed down a little bit, but always good to get a lot of playing time across the board and really keep some of your guys fresh. Gabe Wilson's been banged up 2 pretty good times. Good sprained ankle, a thumb injury. Going to be wearing a brace probably the rest of the season or until he has surgery. So being able to sit him a little bit probably is a good thing.
Scoring looked like this. Jaden Leth had 12. George Vargas had 3. Josh Cruz with 6. Lawton Shipoff with 9. Kobe Dalma with 3. And Alex Billings with 2. For the Jays, Trevor Teal had 15. Tied the Jays with Gabe Wilchin, also had 15. Landon Knipe with 5. Nolan Teal with 7. Landon Ryder with 3. Jackson Kramer with 6. Aiden Langle with 5. Zach Harpinaw with 1. Carson Arns with 5. Caden Hanks with 6. Dane Lehman with 5. Jays really dominated this. The second quarter was just an out-and-out domination of between both teams. And the Jays, for the boys, they just kind of out-physicaled, I think, HMS, which for an HMS team is kind of a little bit of a shock, knowing how physical they are as a football team.
It was they really picked apart that 2-3 zone in the second quarter. It didn't take them long to realize. I'd say to start the game, the ball movement was kind of slow. They're passing and look, pass and look. And instead of pass and kind of already thinking where the pass needs to go next and anticipating. And once they had it figured out, they really picked it apart really quick and got a lot of easy layups. They weren't really settling for jumpers. And then once the easy buckets start falling, then the outside shots will start falling with it. So, second quarter was just a very good ball movement quarter.
Jays are on the air on Tuesday night as they take on Remsen St. Mary. That'll be on Remsen St. Mary's Fuller Digital Solutions channel. The next time we are on the air will be in the new year versus Akron. That will be on January 2nd. Tip time will be 6 o'clock as the girls take on. Girls take first billing, and then the boys will follow. That'll do it. On behalf of Drew Bickford, I'm Matt Schilling saying so long. Have a happy and Merry Christmas and a happy and safe New Year. We'll see you next year.